Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Sleepy.
You got coffee?
Good morning.
I should make some.
Oh, I can't function without coffee. I turn into a really unpleasant person. Like total baby. If I don't have coffee, I need coffee. Good morning, existential. How are you? We were talking about coffee. Do you start your day with coffee? There's a thumbs up. That's good. That's good. The thumbs up and the 100%, then that's definitely coffee. Do you take cream in your coffee, existential? I like this communicating through an emoji. Yep, a heart. Okay. We should just try to have a whole conversation and just see how far we can see how well we can communicate with emojis. I'm not sure if it'd work. Ah, there you go.
Cream and coffee to start the day.
Yeah, nice. I can do black coffee if I have to, but it's yeah, cream. Gotta have something.
It's funny because I used to drink it black. I preferred it that way. What, let me ask you this. What cream do you use or prefer?
Usually just milk, 'cause then it just I don't know, then I still get the coffee flavor, but lately I got some of those like holiday spice, the flavored creamers, and I mean they're good, but they kind of ruin like the coffee. Yeah, the thumbs down. I know. It's like you're either gonna taste all that flavor or taste the coffee. So usually it's just milk or sometimes half and half, but I like actually to taste the coffee too.
Well, that's I don't pour the cream in my coffee. I have it in a separate cup, and I kind of sip both.
Oh, that's an interesting
So,
way to do
and
it.
I like the Irish or the Italian sweet cream, which is funny because somebody from Italy told me they don't even have cream.
Oh, that's funny. I know it's all these things that we've thought of that probably really don't exist everywhere, like French fries. I don't know that they're made in France. An Italian sweet cream.
Ex yeah, I use that example too. French fries and French toast.
Do you remember Freedom Fries?
For some reason, it sounds familiar, but I can't recall what it was.
Yeah, I think it was around 2001. It was I don't know, like France was gonna remain neutral with all the events that were going on in the world. And so people stopped calling them French fries and called them like Patriot fries or Freedom fries.
That's crazy.
Maybe it was a small circle.
That is wrong in many ways.
What do you guys got on your agenda today?
This, talk about freedom fries. How about you?
And coffee. I'm trying to get a small collection up on Tezos. I played around with AI a little bit with some hedgehogs, and they're pretty darn cute. So,
I think I saw those. Did you post those like was it a week ago? I saw somebody with cute hedgehogs.
yep, that was me. It came from I was listening to a Shark Anthony Twitter space, and he was talking about he had a had had a pet hedgehog, some time ago, and he was looking, it led him to look for hedgehog NFTs, which it took him a while, but he did find one. And I just had happened to be playing around with AI, so I threw in a hedgehog and a DJ and came up with pretty cool ones.
That's awesome. Hedgehogs, I used to have one. They're a pretty fun little pet. They're pretty interesting. So that's cool. That's a cool project that you're working on. The AI is like mind blowing.
And the magic number, the total number is 69. But I know Billy's not in here yet. Or
so you're gonna mint 69 of these different NFTs. Are they one of ones?
Yeah, they're all pretty much. There's some as an astronaut, there's some as a Jedi Master, some as a Sith Lord, some as DJ. A few of them, there are only one type, and in particular is the Teenage Mutant Ninja Hedgehog.
Oh my gosh, that is awesome. Are you still making them? Like, have you finished all of them, or can we put in requests?
I have finished them, and I've not been able to replicate the way the AI was going that day. So I tried some more, and they come out weird and not the same. So, but I'm going to play around eventually with lemurs and ferrets. So if you have a request on one of those, I can certainly give it a try.
Okay, I also had a ferret once as a pet, only for like 2 months because they are so smelly, but those are cute. That's kind of cool that you can't replicate the process, like, because then they are unique, and then the next, you know, season two or whatever, series two will also be unique.
Yeah, I do kind of like that. And I had a ferret as well myself. They are, even if you have the smell gland or whatever removed, they can still have a stench, but they're pretty cool.
Yeah, they are. Oh, I love our conversation. Coffee, freedom fries, ferrets. Good morning, everybody. Dr. Drip, KJ, Potra, Brandon, Alpha, Nina, Don Julio, Ariel, Jim. And Cardinal, welcome everybody. Good morning.
What? Don Julio is here? What's up, brother?
I like Don Julio just made a post about printing. I was curious, is it 3D printing possibly, or like printing paper? I guess do like a thumbs up if it's 3D printing and a heart if you're like printing paper. Silence. I'm just, oh, a heart. Okay, what was the option? The paper, right? Did I just say paper? Paper, awesome, cool. I want to hear more about it, Don Julio.
All right, definitely coffee time. I swear, I have the world's squeakiest door.
You definitely do. It sounds like a sound effect from a movie. So for anybody that is in world, oh my gosh, that new chat. It's freaking me out. It's a Metaverse Fashion Week chat. And somebody's got to help me if I can override it, because like right now, it just keeps coming up and I want to talk to people nearby me. It is wild. I'm not sure if that's how it's going to be for the whole festival. So anybody else in world and trying it out and seeing, like, there's 572 people part of it, kind of talking all at the same time.
Is it still doing that thing that I think CK mentioned, where something, the conversation appears on top of everything else?
Yeah, it appears like it is. And then, so I'm trying to talk to somebody nearby me, and then the Metaverse music festival chat is showing up above that. But if I sit idle for too long, it brings up the metaverse chat. So then if I like go back to try to talk to somebody, it would automatically throw me into the metaverse chat. So now I feel like if I could be wrong, still drinking my coffee, but it feels like you're going to have to make sure that you're in the right chat, like just to talk to people nearby, because it's going to default you into that other chat. So if anybody has go ahead, extend.
Maybe a default thing they set or something. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, I have yet to play around with it enough to be able to say, like, hey, use this one or that one. When I bring up the options, it just says, like, my only option is leave the channel. I don't know if I leave it. Will I be able to come back in? I'm not sure. So it's interesting. If anybody has played around with the channels, please feel free to come up and tell me what to do. Because this is, this is going to be interesting to have, like, a giant DCL group chat for the whole Metaverse Festival. I'm not sure about that.
I haven't been in World for quite some time, so I'm going to go check it out. Did you check in your settings, perhaps?
Ooh, good question. Let's see. Settings. General.
I see Neha is here as well as Josh. Super Nina, welcome. Isle, good to see you.
So for the chat, I don't immediately see settings, but I'm still looking. I'll let you know if I find some.
I'm excited to be one of the kinetic emotes winners.
Oh yeah, can you tell us more about that?
I wish I could, but I have not received them yet. All I know is that they won, they're for the music festival, they won the emote contest. So it's emote specific. Well, I guess there's 10 of them. I don't know that we get all of them or just one. Good question. Now I'm really excited to find out what it is that's coming.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Is he or are they a new company entering the space or new, you know, creator entering the space?
I want to say yes. I think they're with Fashion. I'm going to go check them. I'm going to go look them up here.
Okay. The reason why I asked is because, like, one time I was, like, just scrolling through the marketplace through different emotes, and I came across one of theirs, and it was, like, at, like, originally priced at, like, 20 mana a piece, and then, and I saw that, like, one community member like bought one, and then shortly after, like 2 days after, it got dropped to like 5 mana a piece, and I was like, no.
It says they're 3D creators, and it was, we won the Decentraland Metaverse Music Festival official emote contest. And thank you to CK Bubbles, who I was one of the three that she copied or sent it to enter herself. So never won anything like that. It's pretty cool. I hope.
That's awesome. What, tell us about the emote that you, is that the one where you made the emote and submitted it?
No, they did. They won it. They, to celebrate that them winning the Metaverse Music Festival emotes, they gave away.
They're giving some
of whatever they created away, and I'm going to be getting one. So
that's awesome. We need a emote contest now, like I don't know, like where you go perform it in world and like whoever. I guess it's like DCL's Got Talent. Could we do that?
That would be cool.
I'll just go there with my bong rip, and that's all the talent I got. Just and loop it.
I'm still disappointed that one of you hasn't made a bat wearable with a biting bat head off of bat emote.
I know there needs to be a bat in hand wearable, and I'm not talented enough to make the wearable yet. So if anybody can make a bat in like a day, I can make the emote. And I guess you could have like a sandwich in your hand too then, and you could have like, it could be like taking a bite of a sandwich, like just giant rip it. Or I guess you could like bite the lid of a Cove beer off too, maybe, I don't know. Good morning, Tuda. How are you?
Hey, how are you? I just heard you talk about that. There is a bat emote. A bat in mouth. There's a bat in mouth wearable.
I've seen that one, so I'm not sure if you could like make it look like the hand. Like maybe the hand would go up and you'd be struggling to like bite the head off. I guess that would be.
Well, yes. Don't you have like that drinking beer one?
I have a few drinking beer ones, yes. So, unfortunately, that's my contribution, is just a lot of beer and weed smoking and passed out.
Well, I was going to say, because, I mean, if you, like, it almost looks like, too bad, like, you can't have the bat in, like, within the hand, essentially. Like, almost like the beer, like, it looks like he's, like, you know, biting the bat off, I guess. I don't know. But, yeah, that's all I wanted to say. There wasn't, because the Holy Ones were originally, like, it was kind of in their plans to make one, and of course it came out, so they had a, like, you know, obviously they whipped something else up, but so someone came out with it. It was a great idea, whoever did, but yeah, I just wanted to make sure you knew.
Yeah, thank you, that's awesome. And Don Julio, good morning, welcome. You are up and you've got the floor.
I think we lost Don Julio.
Oh, well. I thought maybe it was me. I don't know.
Maybe it was a connection issue. I know that it'll kick you off the speakers panel if, you know, you have shaky connections sometimes or, like, just go into a shady spot. But feel free to request to come up to speak if you'd like. Existential, your hand is up.
I wanted to ask if I could pin twit something from the Kinetic. It's about their emotes that they mentioned. If you're interested in more about them.
Yeah, for sure.
All right. And then I guess while I'm up here, I would like to. So there's a rock, paper, scissors tournament coming. And hoping to do possibly a pre-tournament type thing to bring its attention. And Kanessa, I think you know where I'm going. I was wondering if Sinful, you and Kanessa would like to go up against each other in a I don't know, just a special tournament. And the emotes would be provided to you, so.
I've thought about this long and hard. I'm so totally down to support it, but I don't really think I have time to compete. I have been wanting to.
Fair enough. Thank you.
Yeah, I like the rock, paper, scissors combat battle. It's been pretty cool to see Sir Dijon build that up, and he's got some cool stuff going with it.
So how about the electronic monies just like dying overnight?
Yeah, that price of mana. That's pretty wild.
I opened up a long on mana and decided to take a nap, and it didn't go anywhere. It just, like, stayed at, like, 53 cents for, like, 3-4 hours, and then it just freaking died. Again. Yeah,
so does anybody in the room know where Bitcoin's going? Just kidding. I mean, nobody knows where Bitcoin's going. But
oh. Obviously to the moon.
Well, before it goes to the moon, I want it to go somewhere else.
You sound like a bear, Knessa. Are you a bear?
No, I'm just a scooper. I want to scoop it up, but I don't want to scoop it up at 20,000. I want to scoop it up at maybe 14,000. How's that?
Holy crap.
But I don't want it to go there. I don't want it to go there. That would be devastating, but I like where it's at right now.
Buy the dip.
Yeah, I mean, according to all my charts on the stream chat, if you just look at them, all you see is like blue arrows all the way down, signifying all my buy orders. God, why am I like this? I see Don Julio came back up to speak. How are you doing today?
Hey, what's up, guys? My bad. I was having a connection problem.
No problem. It's really nice to have you up here. Was very, very nice meeting you the other day at Genesis Plaza. What has your experience been like so far on Decentraland?
Oh, it's been good. Like, you was like one of the first people to like really like just try to help me. I've been like moving around a little bit in Decentraland just on my own, but it was never like with no guidance or people that's just been in the space before, so you was like the first person to really step out and like help me. So that's why I was like, that's why I subscribed to your Twitch and all that stuff, because that was helpful and I appreciate that.
I mean, it puts such a big smile on my face to see your sub on Twitch. I really appreciate you. And, you know, as I mentioned, you could always message me or anything if you ever had any questions, or if you even just want to know where the party's at. Like, usually I can point you in the right direction. I think my friend Tang Poco had mentioned that you had dropped into the dollhouse the other night.
Yeah, I pulled up on them just randomly just to see what it was about. Yeah, they was in there turned up a little bit.
So tonight, at Dollhouse at 9 p.m. Eastern, there's going to be it's a weekly event. It's called Wag Me Wednesday. Mm-hmm. So if you would like to jump in, like, usually like people come out to that, enjoy the music.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because Tang had added me recently. I think it was like right after you guys added me. I guess he's seen me talking to you guys, so then he just added me.
Nice. Her Twitter's usually got everything, all the information, upcoming events and stuff. He does very well at all that.
Yeah, she seemed like she had a lot of people there when I jumped in on a random, just jumped in just to see what it was like. Because I seen it on her Twitter profile, so I was like, oh, let me go see. So then I just went and seen it. It was nice, too. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff I want to do with Decentraland, but I'm just trying to get my feet wet and just, you know, understand how the space works and how people are in the space and just get like connected to who I am first, because I have my own clothing brand and stuff. You know, I was just printing. I just got off work. I was printing. I do print on paper, yes, but I'm a screen printer too. So I screen print like garments, clothing, and stuff like that. So I've been doing that for a long time now. So, and I have my own brand. So I'm trying to cross over into Web3, but I'm just taking my time. I don't want to rush.
And I mean, entering the Web3 space, that's pretty much the right approach, like, kind of like, you know, you said you're getting your feet wet, you're meeting people. That is in my opinion, that's like kind of how you kind of show everyone around you your intentions. Because if right off the bat, you know, you're coming off by just you know, telling people about your brand, people kind of, I don't know, it's like a different way of introducing yourself. And sometimes I feel like it's not as effective.
Right, that is true. That can be true. So that's why I've just been taking my time and just getting to know people and just getting involved in with the space and what people like and stuff like that. So.
What has been your favorite thing on Decentraland so far? Have you played any like play to earn games, or have you attended any events that you want to attend like weekly now?
I haven't been to any weekly events. The only event I've been to on Decentraland was in World of Women did a little event with, I think it's called Realty. I don't know the name of it. They did a space where they had like a little like drop of clothes and had like 20 or 30 different looks. I went to that event. That was pretty cool. I'm gonna go to Metaverse Music Festival for sure. So I'm looking forward to that though. If anything.
Nice. Any performers that you're looking forward to seeing?
Yeah, I'm gonna be at the LimeWire stage. So like all them performers like Soulja Boy and stuff. That's the type of stuff I grew up on like as a kid. So to see it like in a different way is like, it's unique because it's like I'm experiencing it from a different perspective, but at the beginning of the perspective, if that makes sense.
Yeah, for sure. I like the comment, you know, the Soulja, because Soulja Boy will be playing and LimeWire, it just hits me in the, it hits me in the teenage years, basically.
Right.
You remember the days of like, you know, just risking giving your PC herpes so you could download a 3 minute long song.
Right. All the Soulja Boy songs, all the Lil Wayne songs, like yeah, for sure.
yeah. All my Soulja Boy songs were downloaded off LimeWire. Fuck.
That's facts. That's why they went and scooped them back up. They already know. They like, all right, we just gonna redo it and do it on Web3 now. I didn't even know they went to Web3 like that. I just recently found that out. I'm like, oh, they really changed their whole thing to Web3. It's crazy.
Yeah, this year they recently popped back up. I know that they were kind of around like last year or even before that. I popped into the Decentraland. They had dropped a hoodie that you can kind of. If you go in the marketplace and type LimeWire, it's like 1 or 2 mana. Very cheap compared to the new one this year.
Right. Yeah, I bought some stuff already off the marketplace. I only bought like 2-3 things.
Nice.
I'm bidding on a couple things too.
I like to see that you had no trouble bridging into Polygon mana.
Oh, no. I learned fast, so that's why I said I kind of been messing around with it already a little bit. So once I kind of got the idea down, it was like, okay. I just don't like the fact that I can buy some mana off Decentraland and then it take a little while to get there. That'd be having me kind of scared. I'd be like, is my mana coming? Like, I'm ready to buy what I'm trying to get. And it's taking time. I'm like, oh, my God.
Okay, so there's a faster way. What you can do is off your exchange, let's see. Since FTX is dying,
right.
Perhaps not, maybe now you can do it. I think you can do it off of Binance and crypto.com. You buy Matic and when you're transferring it out, you send it to your MetaMask, but mm-hmm. through the Polygon network.
Oh, so do it through Polygon?
Yeah, don't send it through the ETH network or else like your Matic will show up on your ETH network, you know, MetaMask wallet.
Yeah. See, I'm still just now getting like, because I finally understand like, okay, it's an Ether scan and it's a Poly scan. So I'm thinking like, oh, so it's probably one for every type of cryptocurrency that you want to be involved in. Mm-hmm. So I'm just now starting to figure all that out. So like, okay.
Yep. So once you transfer the Matic, then you can just swap it within your MetaMask wallet into Mana, Polygon Mana, and the fee will be like 1 cent.
Oh, okay. So it's cheaper.
Yep. And always make sure to keep like a little bit of Polygon, some Matic in your Polygon network. Yeah, that's like the gas token.
Yeah. Okay. You know, I've been learning just off trying stuff, so it's gonna be a little journey, but I'm fully devoting my time next year though. So next year I'm trying to get all the way in this time. So.
Yeah, and I mean we definitely have some like community members. Like once you're like ready to get your brand into the space, we definitely have like some community members that can help you. Alpha Angels down there, he's with Beavers. They specialize in like kind of the business aspect of getting into the metaverse, so that he could definitely help you out. And I mean everyone else in the room as well, like they're all knowledgeable in their own way. And Knessa, did I cut you off?
No, but I was gonna say, I was gonna ask Don Julio, like you said you do screen printing. I would love, like, if I could go to somebody and be like, hey, I want a screen printed, you know, Decentraland t-shirt, and it like make it a streamlined process or something, or like if Dr. Drip had, you know, his design on a shirt, or I see like KJ in the crowd and AJ and Ruston, but like it would be cool if somebody could make those for Decentraland people.
Oh no, yeah, I definitely could do it, because the way I do it at my job is a little different. Because, you know, usually when you screen print, it's direct to garment. So as in, like, it's a stencil, basically, with a squeegee, you press the ink through, and then it goes directly to the shirt. But the way we do it is basically I basically screen print heat transfers. But the reason we do that is because heat transfer vinyls are kind of like, they're not that good on the quality-wise. So we screen print them basically in basically the same way, but now all you have to do is just heat press it on the shirt instead of having it printed directly onto the shirt, which gives you the option to pick and place wherever you want to put it on the shirt. So they have it to where like it'll have a main logo and then it'll have a bunch of side or like smaller logos that you can just pick and place wherever you want. So basically you almost can customize like your own shirt with certain logos and stuff like that. So it's pretty cool, I'm not gonna lie.
Like looking at the PFPs in the crowd, I mean, I could see like Scott, your little monster on there, like Brandon, your Moses. I mean, I know you can go to other screen printing places and get that done, but I see that like Don Julio is a huge, there could be a huge audience in DCL. Like I would love to be just rocking or like walking around the street, rocking Dr. Drip stuff. And then somebody's like, what's that? And then like, there you go. You can tell them about the, you can evangelize them about the metaverse.
Right. No, yeah, that's definitely because when I plan on getting my brand into the metaverse, I want to do like digitals and stuff like that. So I'm gonna try to like play around with some things here and there and print my own things and then make the same type of shirt wearable in like Decentraland or something like that. So
Knessa, you were mentioning about like walking down the street using or wearing Dr. Drip gear, but the thing is that like Dr. Drip is so versatile. I feel you can like put like two pieces of cucumber on your eyes and still be rocking his brand.
Well, that would also be a conversation starter. I guess I could just put cucumbers on my eyes and walk down the street in hopes that somebody asks me about the metaverse. That's true.
And I
don't think he can send them any because, you know, he sent them all out, but oh my gosh, we need a cucumber eye shirt, Dr. Drip, because those things are going to live forever in Web3. We're going to find them like places we don't know that they are.
If you want, I'll give you IP rights for the Mew bubble and you could just stick cucumber eyes on it.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, I'm looking at it imagining how that would work. Wow. Yes. That's awesome.
Don Julio, what are like whenever you do decide to like, you know, fully get your brand in the space, what are you were mentioning that you're thinking about doing some digitals, like do you have kind of like clothing brand in mind, some designs?
Oh yeah for sure, because that's what my brand is, like a streetwear clothing brand. So and then that's why I screen print, because I screen printed, it made me screen print, because I started my brand before I was a printer, and then after I started my brand helped me learn how to print.
That is sick. I mean, you're learning the market as you're working. So that's the way to do it. And I had a follow up question, but I lost it. Kanessa, take over. I'm sad.
No, I'm just like, as you're talking, I'm listening and just thinking about like brands coming in and this, you know, younger generation and just how amazing the opportunity is to come in here, build your brand. I mean, Brandon's always telling us like, build our brand, get to work, get busy. And I think we're seeing it like right in front of our eyes. So many ways that we can make that happen. So Don Julio, I'm glad you're here. Even just to get this conversation flowing. It's awesome.
So I mean, I feel like I'm a little early into the space, at least for the type of audience and people that I'm involved with. Still kind of like early, because a lot of people that I know or that I'm involved with, they don't really know too much about Web3 or anything that's going on with that yet. So that's why I want to come in and make friends with people who's already in the space that's already established. So when I do try to onboard new people, I won't look like I'm not knowing what I'm talking about. Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I'm still learning stuff. Like Alpha taught me like how to mute the chat. I was like totally struggling this morning with this new chat. So, and then even, you know, optimizing the computer to run better, like we're always learning something. So definitely just having that growth mindset is the big step is just not closing the door and thinking that I got all this. I know it.
Too much for me to even feel like that.
So one thing that like, sometimes I like to ask new users, like, how did you find DCL? Just because I think it's important for all of like people listening, you know, who have been in the space a while. Maybe the things that brought us in are different. Like the catalysts are different. I mean, in the last November, you know, there was the Meta announcement and that brought a lot of people in. Or last, was it October, the Metaverse Festival, that brought a lot of people in. So I'm just curious. I think it's like a cool piece of information that we can all kind of use. Like how, just because you're new and got to pick your brain, how did you find Decentraland and like what made you come in?
Years ago, probably like 2 years ago, I wasn't really involved with it, and I didn't have a laptop or a PC at the time, so I just knew what it was. But I was on a Clubhouse space back then. This was when Clubhouse was still a thing, so I was on the Clubhouse space, and they was talking about it, and I was just like, oh, "What is this? Okay, let me go see." Went, seen, was like, "Oh, this is interesting." Didn't have a laptop or a PC at the time, so I just didn't really double back around to it till later on last year, when I fully got more involved into crypto, because it kind of tied in. Because I didn't really understand everything. You got to like, because me as a new user, I feel like you got to know about crypto and all of that stuff to even like kind of get a grip of what's going on with Web3 and like Decentraland and stuff like that. So it wasn't until I really like got more involved into crypto to kind of like make me want to dive more into like Decentraland and Web3 and stuff like that. So, I mean, but it started with Clubhouse. Kind of gave me like idea of what it was, then it moved to crypto, and then once I got more involved into crypto, that made me more involved in Web3 and Decentraland and things like that.
So Don Julio, you had made a statement that you said like you found Decentraland through Clubhouse back when it was still a thing. I would like to report that I found out about Clubhouse maybe like 4 days ago, and my life has changed. It's basically an app full of Twitter spaces, yeah. And like everyone is just going hard in there.
Basically, I feel like Twitter just copied that. And then like a lot of people that was in Clubhouse back then, a lot of people came from Clubhouse and just started making Twitter space.
Yeah, yep. I mean, but like Twitter spaces are like the soft version of what a Clubhouse room is. Like you enter a Clubhouse room, you don't know what you're walking into.
So many different type of people in that space. Because I feel like Twitter spaces is more like, at least the Twitter spaces that I'm involved in are, my Twitter spaces are more involved with like crypto and stuff like that. So I feel like they kind of like took that group of people and just was like, hey, we're going to make Twitter space for you guys. So come over here so you don't have to deal with all the trolls and stuff over there in Clubhouse.
Man, Clubhouse, I love Clubhouse. I was just randomly scrolling and I saw 21 Savage in a room, and I just like popped in there and just started listening. They were going in. They were arguing about they were all arguing about whether Virginia was considered the South.
Because 21 Savage and them, they've been on Clubhouse since like the beginning. Like, they the ones who really made Clubhouse kind of like popular, like, and have everybody come to the app, because they was just like doing a lot of cool, like, little weird little stuff just in the Clubhouse, having fun, making people laugh. Just, and then they was also inviting a lot of people in on the space. So it was like, oh, 21 Savage, okay. And then more people started coming. Next thing you know, you're in there with Drake or Metro Boomin or something crazy. And it's like, what the heck? So yeah, that's how that started, at least for me.
Oh, okay, I see. So 21 Savage has been doing it. I see. Yeah, damn, yeah, I got debated. just learned about Clubhouse. I am a fan. I see that we have been on for like about 41 minutes. Just want to remind everyone in the room to like and retweet the space. If you like what you hear, tell your friends. Also, make sure to give a big hug to the person next to you, if you can. Maybe you're on Decentraland and can't give a hug. And I would like to invite anyone that would like to come up to speak. If you're doing anything fun for the Metaverse Music Festival, or have any fun events coming up, want to talk about any updates on your project, feel free. Thank you. Ooh, existential. Oh, sorry, Knessa, did I cut you off?
I was gonna I noticed existential too, so nope, you got it.
All right. This is I found something for you. I don't know how you get back to it, but on the chat box, you open up the chat box and you click a channel, and then the three dots up at the top that says you can leave the channel. Have you tried that?
For the, I didn't, because I'm afraid. So Existential is talking about the new chat box in Decentraland. I didn't. I was afraid that if I leave, I won't get back in. But Alpha told me there's a bell. And so all I had to do is click on the bell to mute that channel. Because it's pretty overwhelming, and it, for some reason, the Metaverse Music Festival is the default, so it will default even if there's people nearby that you're talking to. So did you find a different Perfect. Way to do it, Existential?
No, I just saw that exit channel and I was the same as you. I didn't know if I'd be able to get back in, so that was a button I wasn't gonna push.
I know. I didn't want to push it either. I didn't know what would happen. I think, you know, we're all savvy enough. We can eventually figure it out, or like we could talk to somebody that will, but this scares me a little for new users coming in. If they're automatically put into this chat, and then there's also the nearby chat, like this could be a huge area of confusion to be looking and having these two different chats come up. So I'm wondering how that's going to go this weekend.
So Knessa, I decided to pick on you a little bit. I want you to go down to the little bubble, like where we comment stuff, and take a peek at my latest comment in there.
In Decentraland?
No, in the Twitter space.
You are so mean. But that's totally me. Yeah, that's totally me. Are you telling me that you guys all figured this out that quickly?
I'm one of those that just goes with the flow. The problem will be a problem once I notice it's a problem.
Well, I was trying to talk to multiple people on parcel and talk here, and so maybe my multitasking like hit my threshold. Maybe that's what it was.
Maybe. And I would like to welcome Wisher Vodka and DevDog. I see Bleece in the house as well. Welcome, welcome, guys. Thank you so much for being here. We have just been degenning, having conversations about degen stuff. Wisher, if you have anything coming up for like around the music festival or any upcoming events, please feel free to come up and give us the update.
Have you guys looked at, like, have you gone and spied on the music festival area a little bit?
Yeah, I was looking at the LimeWire stage. It's pretty cool. I didn't go to the other spaces, though, at the festival.
I have yet to go to the LimeWire spot. How's it looking?
It's cool. It's like a lot of green and yellow neon everywhere. And this is interesting to me because I go to festivals in real life. So to go to a metaverse festival and it's basically the same thing, but like just for like a whole bunch of avatars and stuff, that's cool to me.
Oh man, I share that same like sentiment with you. Like what got me into the metaverse was literally last year's music festival. Like my friend showed me and I was like, what? Bet, let's go.
Right. It's interesting to see like everything from real life go digital and then like actually work.
Yep, I mean, you know, it's not all gonna work all the time, but as we, like, you know, continue to, like, learn and develop, like, kind of what works in Web3, because we're the ones discovering what works. Like, no one knows what works yet.
Right. That's true.
So, I mean,
I feel like people have been doing a good job. It's been growing really fast, at least from the years that I've been looking at the Central Land, like, the clubhouse like 2 years ago to now is crazy. And Spatial. I'll be on Spatial too. I like Spatial too.
Oh, okay. So do you know anyone from the Spatial community that like High CC or MetaMike?
I haven't really got that much involved with the Spatial community yet. I kind of talked to like a couple of Spatial people like Jake and stuff like that, but I haven't really got like super involved with the community yet.
We've had some Spatial Decentraland collab parties. They've been very fun. Like the Decentraland community and Spatial, and I think they're called Spatians. I think we get along pretty well.
Oh, that's cool. Like that, you guys are like pretty cool, like with each other and on two separate platforms, type of thing.
Yeah, I mean, it's not about like whose metaverse is better. It's the way that I see it is just that every metaverse is going to be its own experience, right, with its own community, and so you know it's up to us as the user to kind of like jump around and see what our favorite world is.
Right. Yeah, that's what I've been kind of doing. Like, cause I've been on Sandbox. I've been on Decentraland. I haven't been on OmniSpace like that. That's pretty easy to use, though. Spatial. Spatial probably the most user-friendly, and definitely for people who don't like know anything about like Web3 and Decentraland, just because of how easy it is. You just create an avatar, and you could do it from your phone, and then you're in the space. So I was thinking, like, I maybe use like Spatial as like my new like website type thing. So like instead of having a website where you go and buy my products, instead you would just, the link will be Spatial, and then it'll be like an interactive website type thing. And then on Spatial, I know they have hyperlinks, so I'll just hyperlink the checkout pages to Spatial. So then basically all you do is just go on Spatial and then just check out from there.
Yep, definitely. I have heard that like people in Web3 are using their spatial accounts as a way to kind of as like their 3D Facebook.
Yeah.
They'll send people there to kind of view their work and stuff.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's like an interactive website almost. And at least that's how I look at it. I don't know about everybody else.
No, sir. Novax, I see your hand is up. Did you want to chime into the spatial talk?
Yeah, well, you know, I'm tempted to. I'm probably going to not be able to resist. You know, I'm on cyber all the time, you guys, and I'm really big on custom environment building at this moment. I think it's a very cool thing to be building custom environments, and just specifically with regard to this meta commerce conversation. And that's why I like a platform like OnCyber, where I can link out to OpenSea listings and stuff like that. I'm listing and curating a lot of ENS for my project, the ENS auction. So it's kind of all about that. But we're finding that if you put avatars on the ENS, they like display a lot better in these environments. And there's so many things I'm doing in there with 3D and like video and stuff. Just embedding video of yourself giving a tour of your gallery now becomes like a guided automated walkthrough tour of the gallery. So there's so much with that. But I wanted to chime in on some of the Decentraland talk too, because I've just recently been on a call with Michael Kay and talking with him about what he's been doing and some of the kind of larger contiguous parcels are very, very interesting to me from the perspective of this event this week, you know, and next year, particularly building towards having something like a very large, massive outdoor concert venue on one of these parcels would be extraordinary. And we've kind of coming to some preliminary discussions about what we can do with 3D builders deploying that kind of a space, even just temporarily, and then seeing where that goes.
That's interesting.
So if there's big builders in the room, please get in touch with me. I was just on the call with Ash, you know, from Utopian Renaissance, and my partners with Mazing are really, really gifted. So, I mean, we are engaging with OX Wolfgang as well, like the best 3D builders that we're aware of. So, you know, if you guys know people who are really gifted modelers and sculptors, please have them hit me up. I really like to chat with them.
There's so many friends in this room. Who knows, maybe rip to your DMs. We're gonna see after the Twitter space. Thank you so much for coming up and sharing, and kind of this is my first time hearing of OnCyber. Sorry to like jump back to that one. Is this a metaverse, or sorry for being a noob?
Totally. Yeah. You know, OnCyber is a really interesting metaverse space. It kind of has the, the different scarcity model. So it's not like a single map scarcity. We should have a language for this. I don't really have good language for that right now, but I think like voxels or whatever, anywhere that there's a scarcity and a default relationship between your plot and the location of someone else's plot. Whereas, you know, in OnCyber, there's no, you know, you can create many instances of one space. When you are a space creator and you create a space, you can choose the supply and how many you generate. So there's an element to the strategy of that, the scarcity of the number of spaces. And then you can portal from your space to any of your other spaces, or from your space to any public space of your friends. So part of the fun of that is just laying out like I do at the ENS auction. I have like a friend's portal that goes to all my people who have listed their stuff and that I have curated their works or art within the auction galleries. So it really is like a 3D website. The way that was described is perfect. And that was my first experience with OnCyber, was through B-Card. And B-Card is like an early social media, digital infrastructure, kind of like an ENS or something. But it's just basically 100% on-chain record of who your friends are and what you want to say to them. So it creates kind of the data on-chain data layer for other people to do like visualization tools, so we could have unruggable, persistent, immutable social media. So that's, they were doing it, and they're all low digit holders, 999 club and stuff, with high value assets, all kinds of Damien Hirst on the walls. So I was like, okay, I have a pretty good trust for the security here. Like, these guys are using it. And that's when I started just a few months ago curating an OnCyber, and I've really enjoyed it. You know, I'm not like shilling for them or anything, but it's a fun platform. It's good. There's not a ton of people there. So it would be nice to have more traffic and people through there. And I think that's going to come down to having good middle spaces and portals, you know, inner metaverse portals. So I think that's a good opportunity for people to build the bridges between Decentraland and on cyber and spatial and everywhere else.
Most definitely. And I mean, don't worry. I didn't take it as a shill. The whole time that you were explaining it, I've been taking my notes and I'm definitely going to check it out myself. Don Julio?
No, yeah. I'm just listening. I'm just listening, trying to keep up.
Yeah. Bust out your notebook. As right. You see,
I'm rolling up right now. I'm not even.
Bro, forget my book now. I'm gonna roll up too. Someone mentioned the catnip. I would like to pass the mic over to Wisher Vodka. Thank you so much for being so patient. How are you doing today? Is it Boca or Kalo?
Today it's Boca. Yeah, I'm doing okay. I've been under the weather for like the past week or so since Halloween, so you may hear a few coughs. But yeah, thanks for inviting me up. And yeah, it's cool to hear what everyone's talking about, this multi-metaverse stuff. We've kind of been experimenting with that on our plot as well. I don't know if you guys have checked it out yet or not, but yeah, we've been partnering with another company called Swivel that has built out a custom space for us, and it's really cool. And we've kind of been enjoying having multi spaces. So I think we're going to check out a few of these other ones that were mentioned today. And yeah, just wanted to jump up here. You'd mentioned the festival. We have some news. I can't talk about it quite yet. I'm waiting on the green light. But once I have the green light, we'll tweet it out. So more to come on that. A little teaser there. But yeah, we're super excited for the festival as well. And I was just doing this Follow the Rabbit quest, and I thought that was pretty cool. But man, that rabbit runs really fast. It was really hard to keep up with the rabbit. Have you guys seen the rabbit quest?
You talking about on the festival?
Yeah.
Yeah, she was fast, bro.
Dude, I could barely keep up with her, and it's like you're leaving her area in 18 seconds. We're gonna restart, and I was like, oh man, I need to like hoof it just to catch up. Does it give a wearable? Do you know, Don Julio? Did you?
I didn't get one or anything. They just said you'll do good on the festival, so I'm pretty sure you probably have to do the same thing again just during the festival. I'm not sure.
I see. It's just like we got a sneak peek of it.
Yeah, type of thing.
That's kind of cool.
I think I was at the Swisher space yesterday, I think.
Nice. Thanks for coming through. Yeah. I've been seeing a lot more traffic on our parcel lately. I caught Knessa just hanging out, so I jumped in and spotted her making some content. But yeah, it was cool that you came through.
No, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I catch Knessa loitering on people's plots all the time.
Yeah, you never know who I'm going to be. Actually, Wisher walks up and I'm like, I'm a male avatar with like blue hair and a skateboard. I'm like, hey, and I'm Bjork. And yeah, totally lost my identity.
Yeah, I was a bit confused there for about 5 seconds. So I'm glad you let me know who was behind the avatar, as it were.
Yeah, it's I usually don't rock the style, but I kind of like it. And yeah, it was cool. I was over at Voxboards doing some hand plants with my skateboard, so that was pretty cool. And then I went over to Wisher, did some dancing, saw the giant Wisher bottle. So right. Yeah, it's a cool build.
So I think I saw Brandon in the building. If he's not going to come up, I'll do it for him. Code Brandon for 10% off Wisher Vodka. He's gonna fucking love that.
We get get a real vodka bottle.
Yeah, it's a real vodka. We launched the vodka in the metaverse first, so we're actually a metaverse born company. We are a very real vodka too. And yeah, Brandon 10 I think is the code if you want to support Brandon. Just punch that in at checkout at wishervodka.com.
No, that's fire. Y'all fire. I'm going to let y'all know that. Y'all the first what? Y'all the first vodka metaverse vodka?
Yeah, first spirit of the metaverse, man.
That's
fire. We're out here mixing things up, trying to figure out like what does a vodka look like in Web 3. And so we've just been having a blast, like hanging out with everyone for the past, I don't know, geez, feels like 2 years now at this point. Just kicking in the metaverse, throwing parties, and it's cool to see Metaverse Music Festival back around again a second time. So I'm excited just to see that we guys, like, this is just the start of it. I can't wait till we're all in VR. I can't wait till like you're partying with your avatar, you know, and you got your Wisher in hand as well.
Why is Decentraland not on VR or Oculus? Because Spatial is.
Yeah, that's a good question. I mean, I've heard that that you can do a beta. There's a beta version of it out right now, and I think that they're about to kind of drop more information around that. But I think this year is what I've heard is this coming to us.
This year?
I don't know. I don't know if it meant calendar year or if it meant like, you know, 2023. But
yeah,
I've at least seen some demos of people out there trying it in VR, and it looks pretty sick.
I'm gonna try it. I got an Oculus right now. I'm gonna see if I can get the beta on my Oculus.
Yeah. Does anybody have any info for Don Julio on how to access that?
Oh, it's no pressure. I just was asking.
I mean, definitely if no one comes up at the moment, we could definitely get you in touch with someone that does or does have some experience in... Oh, there it is. Exactly Scott. The person that I was thinking.
Yeah. I see Scott raising his hand down there.
Hello, Scott. How are you doing today?
Hey, Simple. I'm doing really well. How are you?
I'm feeling good. I have a big smile on my face. I have coffee, 3 hours of sleep, you know, living the dream.
Excellent. So I heard somebody mention the VR beta. And yeah, absolutely. You can download it. I'll post a link to the download. But it is beta. So there are a few bugs, but it's actually getting pretty mature. Every month they come out with a new build, and they just had a new build at the end of October. So, I haven't added that one to my quest. It's a little bit to get it started, but once you go through the initial setup, it's pretty easy to add the new build. So I won't go into the details of it, but if you're interested in doing it, you know, you can definitely add me via Twitter, shoot me a DM, and I can walk you through that. And there's also some pretty extensive comments in the Discord server that deals with the people who are developing the VR client.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I think I already added you, so you just gotta add me back.
Yeah, I got you.
I follow. All right, cool.
And just now, Biometa sent me a link to the install, I believe, and I just forwarded that to you, Don Julio.
All right, I'm gonna be on it. I'm gonna try it. I don't know if I'm gonna try it during the music festival. That might be too much, but I'm gonna try it for sure.
Definitely don't try it like first at the music festival with a bunch of with a bunch of avatars there. I would find like a really empty spot on the map and head out there. Yeah, and it also talks about like adding your wallet and stuff like that. You don't need to do that. You can just once you get the client installed on your quest, it's through something called SideQuest. But once you get that added on there, you can just log in to Decentraland as a guest. That'll make it a lot easier. It's a little kludgy. You got to stick your phone in your headset to scan the QR code, or there's some other workarounds, but you don't have to do that. You can just get into Decentraland with your Quest 2 by choosing the guest mode. So yeah, super easy. Make it as easy as possible. Make it as successful as possible.
Because I had some experiences playing with it in Spatial, and I know what you're talking about, like how like a lot of people being in a room can make it like cloggy, and like if a lot of stuff is going on, it can make it like not work right. So yeah, I understand like with that for sure.
Yeah, because even though you can go on Spatial or these other places on your phone, a lot of those use what's called the Unity renderer, and they they rely on what's called client-side rendering. So whatever device you've got in your hand or strapped on your face or on your desktop, that's what's going to be doing the bulk of the processing work. So if there's a lot of avatars there and you've got something like a Quest 2, that's basically it's a smartphone processor that's in there.
Right.
So yeah, go somewhere where there's not a whole lot of people. The client itself, they've been optimizing it. There's something called a scene load radius, and that's just how much geometry, you know, in a radius around you, like how far out they're going to calculate that. So they just sort of knock that down. So only the stuff that's in your immediate radius gets rendered. So that's another way that it's been optimized. There's
some other things in there too. That's good. That'll make processing pretty faster, I'm assuming.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, they've done some things. There's like a dynamic sky in Decentraland. So it's like you can set the time of day, the sun rises and sets and that sort of thing. And they've disabled that. So they've done some other, you know, shortcuts and tricks. So yeah, it's actually, like I said, it's gotten a lot better since they first started releasing it. But yeah, definitely check it out and set yourself up for success, so to speak. So yeah, I think you'll enjoy it. yeah, cool.
Thank you, Scott, for coming up. What have you been up to lately? Are you set? I see that on Kinesa's build we have a welcome to ABC, the Decentraland build, or a little clubhouse.
Yeah, absolutely. That is the main work of CK Bubbles. They're the C in ABC Decentraland. I'm the A, odd job. So yeah, we're just we give tours of Decentraland every Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern time. So yeah, if anybody is interested in getting a tour of Decentraland, you know, come by during that time. But I'd say even in the interim, you know, stop by the, you know, this community gathering that Kinesa has so graciously set up. And I'm planning to be there as much as possible. So we've got the clubhouse there for ABC's tours. You can see some pictures of from the tours. There's a teleport to Vroomway, and there's a giving tree there that I'll be organizing. I just posted a tweet about that. Maybe I'll pin that up here. But yeah, just letting everybody know that we've got close to 700 items in the backpack for the giving tree. And I hope to have zero items in the backpack of the Giving Tree by the end of the music festival, because I really enjoy meeting new people, onboarding new people. So, you know, stop by the community center, and I'll teach you how to do things in Decentraland. I'll send you some places. Maybe we'll teleport together. And as a reward for learning something new, you get to pick something out of the backpack from Giving Tree.
That's amazing. And Scott, have you managed to find a way to automate the Giving Tree, or is it all going to be manual?
So it's going to be manual for right now. I did have a talk with I talked with Pixalia, and he mentioned that he might be able to connect me with somebody who's a developer that can automate it. I've also had just a few general discussions with Matamis. I know it's possible. It's just a little more complicated because there's 174 different wearables that are in there, and those have been donated by people, or, you know, things that, like, I won in Wondermine. Like, anytime I win something from Wondermine, I just get a hat and then I chuck it into Giving Tree. So stuff like that. There's all these different wearables, and they all have a different smart contract. So in order to be able to automate it, I'd have to create 174 different entries in the code to be able to, you know, catalog and distribute that. Because ideally, I'd like it to be so if somebody comes to Giving Tree and, you know, they learn something new, they demonstrate what they've learned, and then they get a wearable, I really only want a new person to get one wearable so that there's enough for each new person. So there has to be like a database that's holding all the people that have been to Giving Tree, and then what item they got. So I have to have a separate database for, you know, for those things. But then I also have to record all the different smart contracts and who's interacted with those. It'd be a lot easier if it was one wearable. I just have to, you know, code that once. So for now, it's just going to be done, you know, in person. The transfers are all going to be done manually. But you know what? It's fine. It's like, I think what really makes the difference for Decentraland above, you know, some of the other larger corporate metaverses is the people. You know, I talk about Decentraland, that it's owned, operated, and populated by the users. You know, that's you and me. So having that person-to-person connection is really what is the unique value add. That's the unique utility that Decentraland has, is the people.
Most definitely. I mean, without the people that are here on Decentraland, it would be a very, very, very empty metaverse.
Well, for sure. I mean, you know, there's value in many different places, right? And I'm not saying this in, you know, I'm not just a personal maxi, you know, for the metaverse. There's important parts in all aspects, you know, all of them working together. It is truly an ecosystem. There needs to be people that that purchase and hold land. There needs to be people that develop. But they're also, you know, we're at a stage now where, you know, if you've looked at Moraz's Genesis.city map, and they have that time lapse from 2020 until 2022, and how the land has developed and how all the parcels, you know, they started out as just green or whatever, and now they're slowly gaining development, and those are experiences for games or whatever, or activations from brands or from individuals. There's test games like Dogman, and I know Isle has some test sites out there, and there's loads of other people. Lastrum has a couple of test sites out there. So there's people that need to develop, but I mean, the ultimate is for us to spend time with each other, right? So it takes all of these different species, if you will, in the ecosystem to make it thrive.
Facts.
I second his statement. Facts.
Yeah, and I just...
Oh, go ahead. Can I say?
Oh, yeah, I gotta give you props, Scott. Scott helped me for, was it 2 or 3 hours? I think 3 hours on Saturday, trying to help a very, just help me figure out how to do DCL Studio. And I couldn't have jumped through those hoops. It would have taken me probably 6 months to figure out how to do that on my own, like bugging a lot of people and getting help. So I just got to give Scott props for taking 3 hours on a weekend to help a couple new people figure this out. So man, you're the GOAT.
Well, you know what? It's my pleasure, Knessa. And one thing that I like to say is knowledge is the one asset. It's the one rare asset that increases in value the more you give it away, right? So if I'm gonna hoard cash or gold or anything like that, it's like, it's rarity, you know, it's the holding of it that increases its value. But with knowledge, if I show you how to do something, then you can show, you know, other people, and then those, you know, that whatever commercial they told two friends and so on and so on. So the more that knowledge spreads, right, it becomes more valuable the more people know. I mean, that's the open source ethos. It's like making things that are accessible and free. So that's what FOSS means, free open source software. And Decentraland is built on that FOSS stack. And the whole reason why we have Decentral Studio or DCL Studio is because the developer, his name is The Shoes. The Shoes just saw a need for more dynamic camera angles in Decentraland, knowing that having content with interesting camera moves would entice people to check out Decentraland. So with that in mind, he coded DCL Studio. So it's a middleware that sits on top of or between Unity and the Decentraland client. Once you get it set up, like we were talking about the VR client, I mean, it's pretty intricate, but once you get it set up, going through and operating it is fairly simple. Like if you've used After Effects or Adobe Premiere and you've set keyframes for cameras, then you can work DCL Studio. You know, you just grab a camera from the list. There's 9 different cameras. You move it around, you set save keyframes. You look at it in the game viewer. You've already seen some tweets out there with this dynamic content. And I defy anybody to tell me that, we're going to go back to that first person or that third person camera, from your avatar that we were limited to. Now we've got 9 different cameras that we can play around with. I mean, it just makes sense to me, Knessa, to share it with you and with everybody else. But I'm an educator like yourself. So that's just, that's how I roll.
Yeah, I think you're definitely spot on. I think we need more content. We need more platforms, you know, TikTok, Instagram, everywhere. And we need to make it look pretty. It needs to be appealing and eye-catching and bring in new users. Wisher and Gold Guy, I don't know who had their hand up first. So I apologize if it's wrong, but maybe Wisher and then Gold Guy?
It was Gold Guy first, but mine is pretty relevant to this topic. Gold Guy, do you mind if I go first or do you want to jump in?
I had a thought.
Okay, go for it.
Yeah. Sorry, I don't want to lose it. So it had to do with the builds, right? So I feel like as a community, we all need to get together and put together a whitelist, like a white paper, like a kind of a soft guideline on what people want in Decentraland. Because what I'm noticing is, yeah, people are creating cool scenes and cool builds, but you know, us as a community, we're only spending 5-10 minutes just checking it out and leaving, right? So I feel like if we had some type of guidelines for people to build on, like what type of experiences we want as a community, I think that'll help the builders and help the developers create a better scene for us.
I think my question was going to kind of address that too, Gold Guy. And I think I was going to piggyback on that and say, I think what I was going to propose was, what if we had, like TikTok and YouTube, they have these creator programs where they incentivize creators to go out and make stuff. And based on like the likes, views, engagement they get, they get paid out, you know? And so what if we put something together where, like, you know, we don't know what's working exactly, but I bet if we were all incentivized to figure that out, and then whoever's got stickier engagement and stuff, like, would get better payouts, would be a really interesting dynamic to really kind of address your question of what's working in the space and how do we create creators that are actually getting paid, you know, to, like, actually, you know, create engaging experiences.
Mm-hmm.
Just wanted to open that up. I don't know if that addresses it, Gold Guy. We can always go back to addressing your questions.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, everybody has, you know, they have their own, you know, that's the beautiful thing about what we're currently doing here is the freedom of expressing yourself through builds and scenes. But I feel like we need to channel that focus onto what we want as a community, like what we look for as a community. And if we can kind of help guide them, even the old builders, new builders, whoever wants to develop in Decentraland, if we could help guide them with like a white paper, like a, you know, here's what we've done in the past and here's what works. And I feel like there's no like library on any of that right now. It's just like whatever you want to do, you know what I mean? And then they create it, they spend a lot of time and money and resources doing that scene, and the community is not, you know, receptive to it. You know what I mean? So we need to, as a community, help guide them what we want to build. I mean, if they're willing to put the time and money and resource into this and use our guidance, I think that's the best approach. And I like your idea, Boca, about incentivizing.
I think it reminds me of like when Pinterest first came on the scene, and like Pinterest had an aesthetic that everyone just followed because that was what was working on the platform at the time. And so maybe we need like that sort of mindset of like, this is what Decentraland content looks like.
Dude, when I was on Pinterest, when I, initially I was like, what the heck is this crap? And then I seen it had like 200 million users on Pinterest and no one knew what it was. Like, that was insane. And I later found out, you know, Google, right? So.
Hey, I think, I know Pinterest is for everybody, but I think, in my opinion, there is definitely like a demographic. I don't know. There's some great casserole recipes on it and like home decor ideas.
Yeah, as like, soon it's as very I seen visual. It, I knew exactly what it was, but I was like, what? It didn't make any sense to me. I was like, okay, yeah. You know, it's like, it reminded me of like a roadmap for like anything really.
Yeah. Well, like, back in 2019, I thought, like I kind of wanted just more engagements, more clicks back to Decentraland. So I started one woman's Pinterest like campaign. So I would find like engaging builds or content, and then I would create Pinterest posts.
Janessa, I found your original blog site for.
Oh, did you?
I found your original blog site like for Decentraland.
yeah. So that's like some good old archives. That's some old stuff right there. Like old. Very old dreams. But yeah, like Pinterest, there was one build that was so dope and I haven't found it yet. I think it was called like the Magic Tree. And back in that time, like it was interactive. You could climb to the top, click on something, and it was so like futuristic compared to everything else that was being deployed. And now it would be like, oh, cool, whatever looks next. But like when you make those engagements and get people, you know, to come back and click on the link and bring them to Decentraland, that was my hope.
Right. I mean, is there like a think tank for you know, develop, like, because like, okay, developers are completely different from creators. Like, I know like people want to like let's just kind of like compartmentalize it, right? So you have the visionaries, you have the creators, and then you have the people that go develop the shit, right? And it's hard to find one person that knows how to do all of that, right? So there's always, in software world, there's always been that disconnect from user interface from the development, right? I mean, this is from any industry. And I know this to be true because I run a software company. What I'm saying is there needs to be a collective group of people that get together and say, hey, there we is need to...
There is.
Where?
Yeah. Who? So Mariano has actually been going to these. It's Wednesday night. It's actually tonight. There's Pad Max in the shoes. They get together. It's a Zoom call, and they hang out and they talk about development stuff. Shawnee's been there. There's a bunch of people that go there. That's just for
the developers, though. I'm talking visionaries. I'm talking people that have the ideas that want to work with developers. There needs to be like a collective or like a Discord channel that they all collectively get together and say, hey, here's what the Decentraland community wants to see. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah, there's a place like that too. Maybe you've heard of them. They're called Beavers.
I know we're trying to get gas, okay? You're funny, bro.
Alpha,
I'm more like hyper focused on this subject matter because I see a lot of cool ass shit. I see a lot of like really passionate builders that want to like keep investing their time and money and resource into their skill sets. And I feel like if they had the proper guidance, dude, I'm telling you, this community will explode in a positive way.
So I think there's a lot of components that are coming up in the mix. So when I hear you talk, old guy, I think about, you know, like brass tacks when the rubber hits the road, right? So to be able to get from the idea point to the activation point, you know, where you've actually got people coming in, you need data. So there's that grant where they're giving us actionable data from parcel to parcel in Decentraland. There's also you know, the land rental, so people can easily access parcels. I know Lastrum has a proof of concept right now. I've deployed the Giving Tree on it in the last couple of days, and I know Art Cibola has done it too, where if you've got a zipped scene file, you can go to his website and you can just deploy your scene, you know, for a day or whatever. And I know that's for his upcoming Last Slices Community Plaza. You know, there's Tobik has the Unversed, right? So I'm writing articles, and so is Existential and CK, and there's a bunch of new people that are writing articles. And you know, it's my goal, my objective to go out and interview as many of the developers that are out there to talk about their project. So the Shoes was the first interview that I did, you know, just to talk about DCL Studio. I've got another interview that's upcoming that's from, it's the 2D retro renderer. So that would be, you know, making Decentraland more accessible in a mobile client. And Fran Tufro, you know, talks about how the reason why he decided on a 2D client, because doing something in 2D is infinitely easier than 3D. So how many people out there would love to hang out in Decentraland with their 2D, you know, 8-bit retro pixelized version of their avatar, you know, hanging out at the dollhouse doing little dance emotes?
I mean, I would like to have access on my phone through the chat. Like, I know chat is way easier to deploy than what you're referring to, but I like to have an app on my phone to have access to the community chat.
So there's already an app on the phone, and you can do everything except for chat and go in world. And I think, you know, again, it's like, this is part of the FOSS, you know, reality. It's like, because it's open and available to everybody, you can do all of these things. It's just that there is no centralized authority that's driving those and that's pushing those. But if you look at some of the more mature platforms like Blender, you know, Blender's been around. It's been out for over 20 years, and it's a fucking killer package, right? And that's partly because it's had that lead development time, and there's been people working on it for so long. So I think we are getting there, and we've got the pieces and the parts to it.
Hey, Scott, real quick.
Yeah.
Decentraland would approach the whole Web3 experience with a communications first approach, we would not be in this position. Be hyper explosive. The reason why I'm saying is communication, like, they just introduced channels, right?
Yeah.
Like, that is a no-brainer, okay? Like, anything to do with in-game
okay, but there's a technical reason behind that, Gold Guy. If you go back and you look at, I think it's either Yamel's or Esteban's, you know, this is from like 5 years ago, and he talks about all the things that he wants Decentraland to do, and pretty much everything that he mentioned in that video 5 years ago has come to fruition. Somebody from that VR/AR San Francisco meetup group said, hey, well, what about chat? What about communications? And his answer then is the same answer now. It's like, if you want it to be decentralized, then chat is more complicated. And there's an RTMP, or there's some easy way to do communications if it's centralized. But if you want it to be decentralized, it's more complicated. You've got the guy who started Twitter, who's now coming up with a decentralized version of Twitter. I mean, I've already gone through and looked for decentralized clone options to Discord, to Twitter. I used to use a service called Mastodon, and it's a federated microblogging platform. And that's what, you know, the Twitter people are doing. It's like, yeah, yes, you can want better communication and you can want decentralized, but there is a technical complexity there that really nobody has been able to crack yet. It just hasn't happened. So it's a great idea, but we're, I guess, the smartest people in the room are still working on it.
Listen,
and I don't think it has anything to do with the
I run a telecommunications software company, right? And partial, you know, we basically, our whole objective, I just merged with another company almost just as big as Dialer. Part of our objectives is to tackle bottlenecks in the communications, you know, and automate the whole entire process through an omni-channel source. But what I'm saying is, I believe Decentraland uses WebRTC open source, right, for communications.
Yep.
And if we're able to, like screw everything else, right, focus on infrastructure and communications, we're able to really hyper-focus this community on those two aspects of Decentraland, we're going to be way better off than we are right now, where the road we're headed. And the reason why I'm saying this is because this. there needs to be sticky points in Decentraland, and there's not enough sticky points to keep people logging in every day, right? Consistently. And this is where we have a problem. It's not the marketing problem. It's not us not, you know, promoting Decentraland. It's people logging in and say, you know, where's my community at? You know what I mean? Like, who do I talk to? And a lot of it has to do with in-game communication.
Right. Discoverability is a key bottleneck. But it's so you've got a software company. You see something that's missing there. Why don't you tackle it? Why don't you take your development, your software company, and develop that? Because that would be something providing an invaluable asset for Decentraland. I mean, that's
yeah, I don't mind the way KYC to get access to that is. To that data and build on that. I mean, I even introduced, like, we did kind of a concept mock-up with you know, okay, in poker, right? I've been playing poker since I was like 12, right? So the part of the poker aspect to it is community. You want it's fun, but the reason why you really go to a poker table is to hang out with your friends, right? And if you go to Ice Poker, it's not even like that. You just go to play to complete challenges. So it's easy to improve the communications, put everybody in a group, in an instance, and you can either chat or do our video, right, through WebRTC. I mean, just that alone would change the dynamic of Ice Poker. If you're able to click, check in, and go to your table and have voice or video chat with people in your table, right? That's what makes poker poker. It's a community game. And this is where I feel like even poker is missing it. This is why I feel like they're going through the trials and tribulations they're going through, because they don't have that it's not the it's it doesn't feel the same. When I go to a poker table in Decentraland, it's like whatever. Like I'm trying to figure these people out. You know what I mean? Like it's and then you got to play the odds. So it's like it's not a community game. You know what I mean? And this is where I feel like we're dropping the ball on this whole experience.
I'm in agreement with you. I think what I'm trying to elucidate for you or for anybody else is the difference in process from a centralized company and a decentralized organization. You know, there's a large amount of money that if you look at the vesting, it's like a 30 degree angle or like a 15 degree angle or something like that. It's 222 million over 10 years. So it's a pretty slow burn rate, and they're focusing on the fundamentals and the foundational aspects of it, which I think is smart. But as Lastrom has said in the past, it's like, you know, there's a load of people that are out there saying, well, this needs to be fixed and that needs to be fixed. And like, okay, so what does one prioritize? And that's why I was just putting it back to you. You've got a software development company. You've got this notion that this would improve the platform of Decentraland. The way that a decentralized free open source software package improves is by somebody deciding to make it better. And they take it and they either fork it or they do a pull request. I mean, you know how it goes. It's like you create the development, you put in a grant, or you decide that, okay, I can monetize this some other way and I'm just going to develop it. I mean, the shoes just decided to make DCL Studio and make it freely available. Now, granted, that's a means of a factor of 10 times simpler than, you know, a platform-wide communications solution. But it's like, I mean, if you see that this is a need and it's an easy solution, then go for it. Make that solution. But I don't know that coming up here and saying this is what we need and, you know, maybe it can happen and convincing somebody to come up with that solution. I just don't see that happening. It's just in the open source spaces that I've been in. And if somebody comes up and says, hey, this is a solution, then what most of the people in the room will say is, okay, here's the source code. Get yourself a GitHub account. Do a pull request. And make it happen.
I just want to jump in, reset the room real quick. The conversation has been amazing. Thank you, guys. Make sure everyone to like and retweet the room. as well as, you know, just follow everyone around you. If you're new, if you're just coming in for the first time and not sure what the Central Land is, just feel free to come up and ask. The Central Land is a metaverse, and we are degenerates of this metaverse. Alpha, I would like to pass it over to you.
Hey, thank you, Sinful. Thank you, Knessa, for hosting these spaces weekly. Appreciate you guys letting me speak here. I'm enjoying the spaces. I still have my idea. I still was holding it. I kind of lost it in between, but it came back. what I was thinking was, when you guys were talking about like finding like out like what do people want to build, I mean, the metaverse is, you know, it's infinite possibilities. You know, it's wherever your imagination can go, you can take it. And I feel like if we can show them ideas that have been realized by some of our community members, like we show them a DCL studio clip of the dollhouse, and then we show them a DCL clip of like the spa or like Ruston's actual spot, and like have it like an actual motion, you know, when Ruston had like the lights going, like that's something that I haven't really seen on a parcel besides someone like MetaZoo, and even a DCL studio at like MetaZoo, like give like these like small trailers to what our scenes are in Decentraland. And I think that could spark a lot of ideas. And on top of that, I was thinking maybe as landowners and venues, we could possibly have some type of maybe Google form or something. Maybe if it's extra, you don't have to do it, but like just something to try and collect, like, hey, did you enjoy your experience here tonight? If not, how can we make it better? Like you know, like little things like that, to just try and like see how we can make it better and to things that more people like. But in reality, I think if we just show them what we are already creating and these like start using that DCL studio a lot more, I think it'll inspire people to take it to like limits even further than what we're doing already.
I think you're right. And I think like on that line, like showing them businesses that like people that are making it happen here in the metaverse. I'm just like looking at the people in the crowd. How many of you guys, you know, have been able to buy something with the revenue that you've created here in Decentraland? Or how many of you work for either like, you know, a company that gets builds or makes wearables? I mean, what we need to do is show people that people are actually coming and building a brand and a business in the metaverse. Because, you know, at the end of the day, money talks. And if they can see like an example of it, that'll speak volumes. So like I try to wear stuff that like community members have made so that I can show off and like amplify the people that are already here. So yeah, I think storytelling, Alpha, like you're right, just getting that message, like that's kind of a weak point, is communicating the message to new people. Hopefully the new people are coming, then we can get better at our storytelling. And let's see. Oh, Biometa, you're coming.
I do know Existence had his hand up. I don't know if he still wanted to speak.
I'm gonna DM you on this one. Thank you, Alpha.
Talk to my man. Welcome, Bio. What's up, boss?
What's going on?
Hello, Bio.
Nice to see all of you guys in the sessions. Want to give a shout out to Sinful and Knessa. Also, shout out to Scott. Everybody in the sessions here. Alpha, Angels, One Existence. DCL family strong, man. I love it. I love these spaces, man, just because we all come together and we share amazing knowledge and techniques that we all wind up running across and learning as we grow. Shout out to Scott, man. I just want to say, man, amazing camera effects. I want to give a shout out to those that are involved in creating that super revolutionary, real revolutionary program for Decentraland. I was really looking forward to asking a question pertaining to that. As you guys know, I work as a broadcaster inside the metaverse, and I had a crazy idea that I was interested in seeing. Maybe does this feature or program, does it offer the capabilities of maybe using it across platforms? Like if I had a Swivel Meta metaverse, for example, and I have different metaverses connected to that space, can I actually add a second avatar and catch multiple angles on the same scene on a live footage or on a live feed? If anybody could help me out with that question, I'm pretty interested in using the program. Not sure if it could be used that way.
Not sure.
Yeah, so it's pre-arranged camera angles that you set up ahead of time. And so if you wanted it to, is that what you're asking? You're wanting it from like two different avatar angles?
Yeah, that's correct. And I'm apologize ahead of time for the background noise. New York's not the quietest place, but yeah, that's exactly what I'm trying to do. Catch multiple angles and different angles with different avatars, and maybe even jump over to a different space. I wanted to know if that's something that can be done only in Decentraland. Is that only available in Decentraland to be used, or can it be used across platforms?
So to my knowledge, and Scott, you can come up if you, you know, can fill in the blanks better. So this is being created by DCL Studios, and that's by The Shoes. And so as of right now, I believe it's just Decentraland based. And you set up you set up the camera angles, and I think there's 8 different choices. So you could, you know, you could set it up as if you're going to have it from a different avatar and then have your avatar go stand there. But it's a little bit different than having an avatar. And I'm going to be quiet now because the GOAT, Scott, is here and he knows all.
I'm certainly not the GOAT. I mean, if there's any GOAT in here, it's The Shoes that created the middleware package. But so Decentraland, the client works off of the Unity renderer and the Unity editor. There are other metaverse packages that also use Unity. I believe, and anybody out there that's more technically knowledgeable than I, correct me if I am wrong, but I believe the list is Spatial, Monoverse, Sandbox, and CryptoVoxels, Decentraland. There may be some others that use Unity. There's a whole load of games that also use Unity. So from what I understand from Shoes, he went into the SDK for Decentraland client and just added some scripts in there so that you can control the cameras. Knessa is right. They are preset cameras, but there's also a free camera that kind of works like you know, your avatar that walks through the world. So if you walk through a world, it's like you've got a camera that's like always over your right shoulder or in first person, you know, where your head is at. So there's that one, and that's camera 0. And then I think camera 9 is the free camera. And you can basically fly all over the place with that free camera. So if you need to get a shot during a live event, you can switch to the free camera and use the AWSD keys and your mouse and your scroll wheel to move that around. But the benefit of DCL Studio is that you have a control panel that you can swap back and forth. So it's just like an edit suite or a control room at a TV studio, you know, where you've got a producer and you've got somebody running the control board, and the producer, the director is like, okay, ready camera 5, go camera 5. Camera 2, give me a wide shot. Okay, ready camera 2, go camera 2. Get me a 3 shot on camera 1. Okay, go camera 1. So that whole time, it's like you've got those cameras that are ready to go, and you're just switching back and forth between them. It's the fastest, it's the least expensive way to produce content, and that's why you have so many news talk shows, because you just get some people, you get some content, you put it in front of the cameras, you get like a 3 or a 5 camera setup, and you switch back and forth between those, and it's called live to tape, or just live, when you record that live. So then you can get some pretty amazing content. So to answer your question directly, Bio, would it be possible to do it across platform? I think yes, absolutely, since it's something that sits on top of the Unity platform, but it is tied directly, DCL Studio is tied directly to the DCL client. And right now I think there's like 6 different versions of the Decentraland client, all of which are being either developed by the foundation or through grants from the foundation. So you've got the browser client, and then you've got the Windows native client. That's the desktop client. You've got the Mac OS native client. You've got the PC VR client, and then you have the Quest VR client. So yeah, that's 5 different clients that Decentraland has right now. And I think the long-term vision for Decentraland is that many people will come in, and Malloy has talked about this a number of times, where you can fork it and make your own client. And I know the 2D retro client will be the sixth different client for Decentraland. So maybe there'd be like a toon shaded only version of Decentraland, or yeah, I don't know. But I hope that answers your question, Bio. Sorry for the long ramble.
Oh man, Scott, appreciate you, my good friend. I was here jotting down these notes, and definitely appreciate you, man. Honestly, shout out to the developers of that amazing program. I'm very much excited because of the fact that I am now creating immersive music videos. So creating a sort of like a small metaverse background experience for those that are interacting with a certain particular music or track. And this is something I saw you post a couple days ago, and it caught my attention because I saw it to be something so amazing and so revolutionary. It definitely caught my attention. So I'm not going to speak too much. I'll pass up the mic. And thank you again, Knessa and Sinful, Scott as well, for hitting me up with all that information and just clarifying certain things that I wanted to find out. Thank you again. And I love all of you guys in Decentraland. Have a wonderful and blessed day. Let's be great, guys. Thank you again.
Thank you, Bio. Thank you for coming up and speaking. I saw that Brandon requested to come up to speak. How are you doing? Good morning.
Bonjour. Hi. Comment ça va, friends? Hello. Welcome. First off, Metaverse Fashion... Wait, fuck. Metaverse Music Festival. That's pretty exciting. We made it. We out here. If any of you make anything, look where that can get you. Literally... We have so many of our own creators that have stuff in the Metaverse Music Festival. Like, they have scenes up next to Ozzy fucking Osbourne, bro. Like, that shit's wild. So, if you are a creator, I'm gonna say it last week, I'm gonna say it next week, I'm gonna say it fucking this week. Keep creating shit. Keep uploading it. If you think your shit is shitty, fuck it. Someone else might not think it's shitty. You know, upload it. Those old projects that you've been sitting on, blow off the dust, quick little polish, and boom, upload it. I don't care. I want to see all of your, like, supplies of content maxed out for people to come in, because this is just another wave of people coming in. So, two, I just got an email 3 minutes ago, right, from people called Metaverse Studios at Decentraland.org. We want to invite you to test out an alpha version of Decentraland Worlds, a new content server that lets you deploy an isolated scene which is accessible by the official Decentraland Explorer. I don't know if this is real, but I just got an email and it says Decentraland Worlds are attached to DCL names.
Is it alpha? Did you say there's DCL alpha in that name?
No.
Oh, okay. Because I know that one is a scam, that there's a different DCL alpha area.
This is a metaverse.studios@decentraland.org. That's the email that I got sent. So if you have a Decentraland name, check your emails. I don't know if this is real or not, but I literally just got it. So that's why I wanted to come up. And if this is real, it looks like anyone that owns a name might be able to put up a piece of land or experience or something. I don't know yet. So I just got this.
Does it have a link to click on, Brandon?
Yeah, I haven't clicked on shit yet.
To our new friends in the crowd, Just you never click on anything. I have like Web3 PTSD when I'm trying to go do stuff and I have to click on something. It's like, no. I'm so scared to click on anything.
I got recently too, so don't accept shit. Especially on Twitter, those assholes. So yeah, I just want to come up, say hi, get ready for the metaverse stuff. I made a video for it on my thing. Check it out. And yeah, love you guys. Dog, what's up?
Thank you, Brandon. Your words matter. And Dogman, welcome. Good morning.
Hey, nighttime for me, but good morning to everyone. Good afternoon, depending on where you are. I got the same email, Brandon, and I just wanted to say, it doesn't look like it's a link. it looks like it's actually asking you to just do a different command in your CLI, which is deploy -x target content. So I don't think that it even wants you to click. I'm not saying for sure it's not a scam, but it doesn't look like it's asking us to even click a link. It's asking us to just deploy the land a different way. So I'm not sure what's up with that. But if it does work, it's a really cool thing. I might just use a complete burner wallet and try to deploy like a, you know, test scene just to see what happens. But yeah, it's definitely not asking you to click a link. It's just asking you to deploy it a different way through the CLI. So just wanted to say that really quick.
I'm so glad we have smart people. I fucking love you, dog.
So now instead of being paranoid that it's like a scam, I'm sad that I don't have the email.
Shame. I wasn't cool enough.
I mean, I'm still, of course, always paranoid that it is a scam. So we'll have to do this on a completely separate wallet and a completely new build and a completely new file. But I'm always hopeful that it's not also.
I just work here, so.
Well, welcome, welcome, CK. How are you today?
I'm great. How are y'all?
Doing good.
I just wanted to add, you guys were talking about this DCL Studios email. So I actually originally got an email from them, I want to say it was like last week, maybe, about their new foundation AMAs. So I feel like this is legit from inside of Decentraland. New email blast using potentially the email contacts for either the DAO or the DCL emails that we receive, if you have opted in for those. But yeah, it would be nice if Foundation and or DAO claimed that this was them, so we aren't questioning who they are. But it seems legit from my side.
I think it would be nice to have a protocol, because I believe it was, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I think that when the Mac client came out, it was actually Miles from DG that announced it before Decentraland did. And so I think that, you know, while those opportunities are awesome, it was like, okay, did Miles's account get hacked? Like, why is this coming from DG Discord and not Decentraland? So yeah, just having like official avenues to go through would be helpful, because there are so many ways to scam. And I think, you know, we get to be so hyper paranoid that I'm like, I don't know, is this link from my good friend CK, or is it, or did CK get hacked? And, you know, this is going to like drain everything. So I think just like for the official things, having a channel that we know it's safe. Brandon?
So this is, it's actually crazy that this happened right now. For one, we just got some major Decentraland alpha about Decentraland, because to me, this is saying like, yo, we can possibly, if you own it, this Decentraland name, you can have not particularly a parcel of land, but your own space, kind of like spatial, I'm guessing, to put up the shit you've been creating. So back to creating shit, make shit. Now you have more possibility to share what you've been making in, possibly, we don't know anything about these worlds yet, but it could be a new place to just have your shit up and ready to go. So keep making stuff, and we'll look into this Metaverse Studios more and let you guys know what's going on, because we just found out about it.
From what you're saying, I like, the only thing I hear is more utility to buying your name. Like, I mean, I have a couple of names, so this is good. I made a good investment.
Man, I wonder. There was some conversation this morning about renting wearables and like the utility behind that. And so I think just because it's not built yet doesn't mean that it's not going to be built. And on that note, I was telling somebody about the thing I saw on like where you go to My Assets and you look at sales for a brief second, like 2 days ago. And sorry, Decentraland, if they're like, shut up, this is, don't make it public. But like for a brief second where it says on sale, sales, bid, settings, there was a tab that said for rent. And now it's gone. And I've, you know, like I didn't think much of it. I don't know, I was like busy doing something else. But then when I came back to look it up, it's gone. So yeah, I don't know. What are we renting? I'm curious. CK.
I think that has to do with land rentals. I think it has to do with some of the grants that's being worked on, and having the marketplace let you rent land. I know that was always something that was being worked on. So I think it had to do with that.
Let's not hope so.
Oh, well, renting dreams. Sorry.
I just had a renting dream myself of being able to rent your name. I mean, they just sit there. So why not? If you,
I mean, if anybody wants to rent, I don't know, I got crazy names nobody would want, but rent names, rent clothes. I mean, everything's an NFT. So essentially, wouldn't it just need, you know, a way to protect the smart contract and have it like an escrow while both parties, you know, agree that it's going to be used? And so I think if they can figure that out with land, then it's just going to be the same for wearables or names. It's just a smart contract. So get on it. I don't know who's on it, but get on it.
Now I can't unthink renting names. Brandon, your hand is up.
I would also like to make a suggestion for everyone in the room for the next... I'm going to suggest for the music festival. No DAO talk. No, I mean, it's obviously important, but we have a lot of new and fresh eyes on Decentraland. And when people were arguing about DAO shit during the last... during the Fashion Week shit, it looked really bad for everyone. So... I would just say we have a lot of emotions and a lot of thoughts in the DAO, and it is important to everyone here. But for the music stuff, I would just a little bit put it to the side. Let's have some fun. Forget about it. Take a step back and remember what Decentraland is originally. It's just a place for us to chill and hang out and actually meet people, probably meet your favorite celebrities and shit. So that was just my suggestion for the next few days.
Love it, Brandon. Alpha, did you want to say something? I see you came back up to speak.
Dude, you fucking lit me up, bro. Like, what if, so let's say you can delegate VP, right? What if you can choose either to just delegate VP, or you can delegate VP and you can delegate the assets like with those VP, and you're kind of like renting, like you're saying you're renting that name. You kind of hook them up with a whole outfit. Cause we was laughing, talking earlier with Canessa, like if you could rent clothes. Now imagine if you just give them some clothes and then you would give them like, let's say, I don't know, like 10 names in VP. It's still 1K VP you're delegating them, but now they have 10 names that they could use. Cause I know you, Sinful, you had a huge... especially your perspective, like you had like a huge glitch with your name where you was popping up as like a rabbit, mouse, frog, like to the point where you had our good friend Artryu just like lend you a name. And he said, here, hold this until you can get a name. And like, you know, like that was love. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think it would be pretty cool if we could delegate names or like even like, yeah. That'd be pretty
awesome. Definitely. I mean, I do remember it was like before I had a name, it would just switch and I'd be like popping into parties and everyone's like, hey, what's up, new guy? And I'd be like, no, it's me.
Yeah, if anybody knows how to fix names, I can't change from Bjork. And so Kness is gone. She's, I don't know when I'll get her back.
No, and she's not. We're getting her back today. That actually happened to me. I got stuck as Meta. And I couldn't get out. What I was told to do, and it actually worked, was I cleared the cache, and then I disconnected it from my wallet, and then I kind of just like logged back in, like from fresh, and then just kind of start from the top, then switch the name, and then it worked. Just try it out. Just try clearing the cache and then logging out, and then putting in.
I'll try that out. Everybody that I talked to, the glitch is a different place. Like Enwiz had the name issue, but he at least could choose a name. He just couldn't get past like the permissions part. For me, when I click on names, it says, it looks like you don't have any names. Click here to get started. The only time I can click on a name is when I mint one. So I would have to mint a new form of Canessa in order to be Canessa. And I forget I'm Bjork, and I don't mean to be Bjork walking around. I just can't. I don't know. I just haven't minted
actually, that name. I haven't heard of. Wait, what? That's actually new.
Yeah, and I have the names.
You don't even have names?
Yeah, it says it looks like you don't have any names. And I've tried it like through the builder, through like changing my name on my avatar. And I've got the names, you know, they're all in my wallet. So it's not like a matter of them getting, you know, they're still there. But yeah, it only shows up when I mint something. So I minted Funko Pop and I changed it. I don't know, a stupid move. And then I couldn't change it again until I changed it to Bjork. So I can just mint something similar, and I should do that right now. And just because I forget I'm Bjork and I'm like, hey guys. And then, you know, it's like a chilly, chilly response. I'm like, oh, it's Knessa. But yeah, I'll try what you said. That might work.
Yeah, that could be a possibility. My version of the glitch was basically all my names were showing up. Thank God. I would click on like use this alias, sign, like do everything, like sign the wallet, whatever, and it would say your, like, you know, your name has been changed, but it would never change in world. But now it works. I'm simple.
That's
now.
Weird.
Yeah, mine like gave me the hashtag back. It was like, here, you're unregistered, and then it wouldn't let me like switch to alpha. It was like I felt so
weird. That's weird.
I felt disowned by Decentraland.
It do be like that sometimes. All right, I see that we have hit our 2-hour mark. Thank you everyone for being here. If there are any new users that would like to come up and ask any questions or any topics that anyone would like to bring up, just feel free to come up to speak. If not, perhaps maybe this could be a good time to wind down. Oh, I saw your hand up, Brandon. Don't get shy on me.
No, stop it. No.
If there are any new users, I have how-to videos on my YouTube to how to use Decentraland step by step, so I got you. And Deadass, if anyone's new and has any questions, feel free to hit anyone one of us up. Tweet us on Twitter. Hit us up in MySpace. You know, do the thing. We're sitting in Genesis 24/7, just ready to help you out, so we got you.
Thank you, Brandon. And I have how-to videos on how to play Decentraland. I love that. Alpha?
I just wanted to say before I said that, I wanted to agree with Brandon before his comment before I went up. Just like, I completely agree, because especially coming from someone who's like, I'm always like frontline anytime it's on. And I feel like for this week, and even moving forward, I feel like with new people, we have to be new again. We have to put this shit aside, leave the baggage at the door, and really just give them an experience they can't forget. And I really think it's important that we do put the bullshit aside when it comes to dealing with new people, because their first impression means everything. You know, we have to really think about our first impression. What would it have been if we came into war and chaos? We would have left, you know what I'm saying? So let's try and make a heaven for these people and have a good time. Let's fucking have fun. I love you guys. I'll see you soon.
Thank you, Alpha. Existential or one existence.
I just wanted to say something. I read something in the DAO Discord just recently, and something everybody should probably go do if they haven't is read the TOS, the Terms of Service for Decentraland. I don't know if it'll help calm some things down, but I don't know. I just think it would be a good idea.
I think there's a lot of gems in there. I think like things that we might forget about. Like I'm just thinking the, you know, user age, 15 years of age. Like if you don't go and read that, how would you know that? So yeah, definitely always good to go back and look for those gems. And I second what you said, Brandon and Alpha. Like it's kind of like parents fighting. You don't want to air your dirty laundry in front of the kids. Let's not let the kids see us fighting this week. Next week, let's not go back to it either. Let's try to get shit done, get shit built. And if it has to happen, let's try to be respectful. But yeah, this week is like, it's a party, man, that we've been trying to build for like a year. And so let's try to invite or get people excited, stoked, and help each other, amplify each other. Yeah, just build some cool shit. Brandon 10, Wisher Vodka.
Oh, Brandon 10, Wisher Vodka.
Can we get, I was going to say earlier, like for if we get like high engagement on our tweets, can we get paid in vodka? We need a vodka token. Or we just need vodka.
Shots. Earn shots at the next convention. That's how we do it.
Oh, God. I the mental picture of that just, wow. Because then we'd have to just make good on all that we've earned all year, all at once. So, wow. Thank you, Brandon.
In one trip, I can't go back.
Remember, beets are a super fruit food.
Yes, actually, Don Julio, that's one thing that makes Wisher Vodka special. It is made from, it's beet vodka.
I know that sounds crazy, but this shit's good as fuck. Like, I'm not a vodka guy. This shit's bomb, low-key.
Yeah, I need some for sure. I'm going to have to hit up somebody and get a little shipment sent.
They also do, I believe they're, I don't know if they're still minting. Are they still minting, guys? Do you know that? Or
they should be, yeah. I mean, I just got my NFT not that long ago. And to Brandon's point, I don't like beets and I don't like vodka, but I like beet vodka. And it doesn't make sense, but it's super clean and smooth.
Does anybody pickle in here? Because I'm thinking we could pickle beets in the vodka. It'd be like a spody for beets.
Totally. I've pickled.
Soak up there. That vodka. Then I'd eat beets.
That's like soaking cherries in ethanol. Not ethanol. Everclear.
I thought you were going to say brandy, but wow, Everclear? Wow.
I like it. So, Gold Guy, you came up to, you requested to come up to speak. What's that?
I apologize for my rug earlier.
Welcome back. How was Rugland? Did you bring back any souvenirs?
Well, I had to do a last minute close, so you know, finalize. So yeah, I just wanted to come up and say I apologize, and maybe I should do some like Gold Guy chocolate bars. we all have to really consider a brand line for IRL. And the reason why I'm saying this is because like back in February, I did some IRL like I took what we made here in the metaverse and put that logo on like an IRL shirt, and you'd be surprised at how many people wanted to buy that shirt. And even like Rustan would be a perfect example. I don't know how many sales you got, Rustan, but you know, I think we all really need to consider branding ourselves in IRL too, you know?
Yep, exactly. I mean, I couldn't agree with you anymore. I think we've had this conversation before. Mm-hmm. Like what makes the monkey JPEGs so special? The reason why the monkey JPEGs are so special is because community members went out and started businesses around these monkey pictures.
Yeah. So yeah, like the restaurants, like all kinds of stuff, like bars, like people will buy that just because. Like, and this is why like brands bought into it because of that reason, because they wanted to tap that community. And also they could leverage that NFT that they own.
Lots to think about here, guys. And anyone want to start a business IRL?
Yeah, I mean, somebody, like you said, chocolate bar, Gold Guy, I've done a lot of like resin casting in my past, like silicone molds. And so like, you know how easy it would be to 3D print your JPEG monkey or your Gold Guy logo or the Mew bubble, 3D print that, create a silicone mold and pour chocolate in it. And then, then we can add some like edibles, and then it's like edible chocolate. But like, that shit's easy to do. And it's out there. Like, can you imagine giving that out at a convention? Now all of a sudden you got just like bunch of little candies, little chocolates. Because I can.
I don't know if I'd be taking candy from strangers at conventions, but.
I'm so down. Bring it.
Would you take candy from me?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah.
And donuts. I will take a fresh batch of donuts.
Oh, yeah. Please do. Please do.
All right. Don, you had any?
Yeah, one thing I will say, being a new person in the space is, like, you guys are, like, the foundation. So, like, you guys literally, I think y'all don't understand that y'all have to do that. Because y'all are the only ones that can. Because people new coming into the space, we don't have the leverage of having, like, all of the, you know, community and things like that. So we got to start fresh. Like, that's why I'm coming in new. So it's, like, because I already have, like, in IRL, pool, I guess you could say. So I already have that on my own, but I don't necessarily have that in the metaverse. So it's like, now I have to come to the metaverse and like start back over again. But I have no problem doing that. But it's like, that's what y'all got to understand, being already in the metaverse, because y'all are the ones who's gonna, like, people like me are looking like, okay, they're here already, so like, let's see what they're doing, so then we could try to like figure out what we need to do.
Yeah, man, and like when you get to a problem, like if you're coming in and trying to onboard your business, I mean, you'll probably hit the same snags that like Ruston did or Dr. Drip or anybody in here. And so like maybe just collaborating and making those connections can move your like new businesses along so much quicker, just because it might be a tiny little door that you hit. Like I was telling Scott, like, a tiny door for, or a big door for me might be a tiny door for him. So having those connections to help you through when you hit a snag is just vital, I think, as businesses grow.
Right. And that's why Bored Ape and like bigger Profile Pic, you know, NFT projects are big like they are, because they have the leverage of both sides. They have IRL and metaverse, like on like even platforms though, like, so they got enough pool in the metaverse. And then they took that pool and then just took it to real life and then got like rappers and famous people and then everything else. So then they just leveraged each other out and they gave it a foundation to where people was like, okay, this has value now just because of that.
Yeah. And an interesting thing that I've witnessed recently, if I can say it, is the Gossip Girl NFT project that a couple of users have come in and seen their PFP avatars. And I would just say, like, one person from that like project that comes in and makes a good impression, and like we start talking to them, and then all of a sudden like people are buying little Gossip Girls. I bought one, gave it as a gift, and I feel like it's suddenly like almost a little bit of a Decentraland, like there's a connection now. It's not a Decentraland project, but there's a connection there, and that's really powerful. Like if a PFP project saw that, witnessed it, realized like how you can build a brand with NFTs, PFPs, but it's all about the people. It's like the people on the ground making those good impressions. So I'm just going to put that out there to the universe. Like it's amazing to see how many Decentraland users now have a Gossip Girl because of one pretty cool user coming in and like just getting involved, like going around helping out and showing up at parties and just being a pretty cool person. So yeah, little alpha, bring your PFP project and be, yep, a good person.
And even to add on to that, it was a very like the investment for the project to like just make a wearable for Decentraland to like to give the opportunity for that one user to be able to show off their Gossip Girl on the metaverse. Like it was a very, you can say that investment will bear fruit in the future.
Yeah. And I wondered, you know, like, so wearable submission fee right now, it's what is it? $150. I don't know what that is in mana this hour. It's different than it was an hour ago, but like you think about a business and all the money that they spend, $150 is like a drop in the bucket, but $150 to make a wearable that your user base can wear in Decentraland is, dang, that's powerful. Like, I mean, I see a lot of linked wearable projects coming in, and I don't know if it's ease of like distribution, but brands would be wise to just pay that $150, That's like a round of Starbucks for the office. Like, put that into a wearable and bring your brand to DCL. Go with drip coffee for one day.
And they don't have to be washed, and they won't fade.
That's right.
That is true. There is no wear on the metaverse. What's up, Brandon?
This week, again, I'm going to say it again. This week is the music festival. There is a shit ton of artists. I don't know if you've actually seen the full lineup, but it's a fat lineup. There is also a bunch of community-made environments, including Vroomway. They made a I had the high score on it yesterday. You know, it's whatever. I'm a bad bitch. Vroomway has their own little racetrack in there. It's pretty sick. True Bandroom is in there. Parcel Party. There's a lot of people in there. Stony Eyes performing. I think Sway's performing. Buffalo was performing, I believe. So, dude, come check out this shit. It's gonna be so cool. I'm excited for it. Take pictures, take vids. There's probably gonna be hella wearables, so come hang out.
Listen to Brandon. He knows. CK Bubbles?
Well, I just wanted to piggyback on what Brandon was saying about Vroomway. I don't know if Doc came up at all during this because I was a little late to the spaces, but yes, we did a collab with Decentraland and the Descent Rally team, and so we have some tracks and vehicles that you'll get to play during the festival. But also, I know we said we wouldn't talk about DAO, but this is something very positive and celebratory. Vroomway just posted our last update of our grant, and I don't know, it's pretty emotional to think about, and I'm really proud of our team, I'm really proud of what we created, and I look forward to what else we're going to do, so I just want to shout that out. Sorry to show a little bit, but...
That's amazing. I mean, Vroomway has definitely done great things with, that initial proposal. And I'm bullish to see, what could be built in the future.
Thank you. Come race with us anytime.
So for anyone that's listening that may... be wanting to do some PvP racing at Vroomway, what would be the best way to find someone to play with?
So the best way is probably the Discord, join the Vroomway Discord. There's a looking for group that people go in, but also one thing that's really fun is at 8 p.m. Eastern every day is the reset. So basically if you have under a certain amount of fuel, we give you fuel back at reset every day. And a lot of us get online around that time and we all jump in the pit stop, which is one of our voice channels, and we all hang out. We just race until we use up all our fuel. And we do that every day, basically.
Well, that's good to know that at 8 p.m. Eastern is the reset. So if anyone wants to race, there's definitely going to be some people lining up. Thank you, Bubbles.
Thank you.
And CK, I know that the Vroomway has a little spot on the parcel on the... community plaza that we are launching just for the music festival. I'm just thinking a new user, if they could get connected to that Discord and be in your voice chat and listen to you guys and be racing, what a powerful way of just getting them in with a community. Cause I think that's kind of what everybody, once we find our community, at least we have a home base to go back to. So, are you guys going to be able to be there as well, kind of helping people get connected and linked up to your Discord?
Yeah, you bring up a good idea. We have a portal link that takes you to the actual full game, because what it will be at the music festival is just kind of taking the Descent Rally demo that they created, and we reskinned it with some new tracks and some new vehicles. But the full kind of experience is on our parcel at -104, -144. And basically, I think I need to put a Discord link there, one of those little tents that you can get in the repository. so that people can find our Discord there. But also, yeah, I've mentioned to the team that we have the space in the community area, and it would be great for us to be there. So hopefully you will catch either Dr. Drip, Nikki Fuego, myself, maybe even Doki, or Neo Cyber, or any of the others on the team who happen to be in World on that day. Hopefully you get to meet one of us and talk to us. We're super approachable, so say hello.
Who is the top fragger at the moment in the Roomway leaderboards?
Oh, gosh. I don't know if Doc, if you're still around and you can jump up. Doc is always, because Doc's the community manager, so he's definitely more connected and in tune with the community than I can be sometimes. Usually I check in sort of later in the day because of my IRL work life keeps me really heads down. But I know the last time I looked, so we're doing a solo sprint tournament right now where the top of the leaderboard at reset every Sunday gets 10 mana, and you can only win that once so that we can share the wealth amongst people and not just have one winner each time. So I know for that leaderboard, it was Limz, L-I-M-Z, was at the top, and I think Sashin was close second, potentially. I don't know if that's changed overnight because I haven't had a chance to look at the leaderboard. But when it comes to our Roomway team, I think we can all say that Dr. Drip is by far the superior racer of the team. Nikki definitely in a close second. I am not so great. I have fun and I enjoy it, but I've never been good at racing games. I'm more of like a FPS shooter game person, so I just go for the experience and to help boost everybody else's rewards since I'm always last place.
that's awesome. I'm gonna have to ask Dr. Drip next time he's up here, like if there are any benefits to, like, you know, top fragging, like either weekly or monthly or all time. That would be that'd be fun to find out.
Absolutely. We always do various activations where we try to take those in the top of the leaderboard and reward them. We've done it, you know, when we had our beta, it was like the first people to reach a certain level got the beta wings, and then the beta wings give you a bonus when you stack it with a vehicle when you're racing. So obviously you get faster times and more rewards. So we're always releasing sort of new events and things like that. So the Discord will be really great. Check the announcements there. Follow us on Twitter. Roomway.io is the handle. I should probably pin a tweet up here as I'm talking about it so people have it. But yeah, so hit us up anytime. We're available. We share as much information as we can. We like to be super transparent. And if you have any questions or any issues, you can definitely submit a support ticket in our Discord. We're available any time of day. And we're pretty quick to respond, I'll say.
Are you as quick as DG? Reason why I ask is because, like, their response time is, like, crazy.
Well, I guess it kind of depends on the day and the time, right? Because most of the team, not all of the team, but most of the team is either Europe or US based. So there's always going to be a middle of the night situation where, like, if one of us DGens isn't up late or up early from the next day, we might not, like, see it. But from what we've been told feedback wise is we, you know, it's pretty quick. I mean, I don't know I haven't done an average of the turnaround time on our response to tickets, but I will say, like, if you're going like more than a couple hours and not hearing from us, it's either the middle of the night we're sleeping or there's no excuse. We usually respond. So you won't be waiting a long time if you have any issues.
That's awesome. Yeah, I personally think like the support team on a project like also says a lot. So definitely like getting good feedback on like your like ticket submissions, like that's awesome to hear.
Yeah, and we love racer feedback. You know, it has helped evolve our game and push for features that we didn't necessarily have on our roadmap in our first 6 months of the grant. But things that we've been able to easily, you know, fit within and activate upon. And we have even future things that people have suggested that take a little bit longer to work on because we are a very small team, you know, doing the best we can. But yeah, like, it's just really cool to see that sort of symbiotic relationship with the racers and seeing how, like, not only are we creating and developing a game, but they are with us. So that's really great.
Thank you, CK. Let's see. I don't I don't necessarily see any more hands up. Are there any more topics that anyone would like to cover? Brandon?
Why are you so cute?
I don't know. I mean, I'd have to give it to my mom. My mom is like, you know, short, adorable.
Thank you.
Thank you, Brandon. Let's see. Don Julio, any final thoughts before we close out?
Yeah, I enjoyed the conversation. I've been here for a minute now, so I learned a lot. And I'm looking forward to just being in the space more and being involved with everybody here.
Thank you for being here. And check us out tonight at Dollhouse, Wag Me Wednesday. I did pin a tweet at the top, so that way you know, you can find it easy, and I also will actually comment it in the bottom so that it can stay in this like chat forever. Little Twitter space tricks. Kanessa, any final thoughts?
I think just take care of yourself. One thing, was it you, Alpha, that mentioned this week is like, it was a really good point that you brought up that after Metaverse Fashion Week, that a lot of people kind of reflected that they were like drained, like they were just kind of tired. And so I think protecting your peace, like it's okay to know that ahead of time going in and like maybe get the sleep that you need and just, I don't know, if you feel like drained next week, it's okay. Like we're all probably there. And sometimes just kind of knowing that ahead of time, at least for me, like it's helpful because I know what he meant. Like Fashion Week, oh, that was rough. Like it takes a lot of energy to do what we do, to talk to new users, to, you know, go, send them wearables, like connect, make connections and do all this stuff. Like I kind of was talking with Shelly and we were like, we need a vacation right now. Like the festival isn't even here and we kind of need a break. So be kind to yourself, be forgiving if you're like, dang, I need a break. And yeah, take those breaks when needed and keep connected with each other because we're all there. We're all in the same storm. We might be in different boats, but we're in the same storm. Or whatever. I don't know. Don't listen to me. That's all I got.
Yes. I'm so happy that you requested to come up to speak. Look, Kanessa, it's all Yay! Money in. Look.
Hey! Yo, what's
and
up?
Don Julio's here too.
What's up, guys? I just wanted to stop by Glad and say hi. You, man. Just wanted to stop by and say hi. I met you guys on the Metaverse. That was like my second time joining. Guys made that experience like really cool and really fun because I would go on there and I'd be like, I don't know what to do, I don't know where to go, how do I get cool clothes? And you guys, both of you guys, you know, hooked it up and showed me the way. And I've been waiting for you guys to go live, so I could come in here and say thank you, appreciate the time you guys took out of your day that night to show me around and, you know, teach me the way. But yeah, I just wanted to say thank you.
Most definitely. I mean, you're always welcome to join us at any events or any parties that we're at. I did invite Don Julio to Wag Me Wednesday tonight. So if you're free tonight, I think I remember you telling me that you work third shift. So if you can make it tonight, like definitely pop in. If not, maybe I'll be streaming it and you can listen in.
Yeah, for sure. Appreciate the invite. I'm actually pulling into work right now. I work second shift. So, yeah, I probably won't be able to join you guys tonight. But definitely on the weekends, I'm free. And I will definitely be in the Metaverse.
Let's go. I mean, this weekend's going to be a very good weekend to pop in since the festival will be going. And there's a lot going on.
Yeah, and All Money, I followed you, like, for you and Don Julio, anybody, like, if you guys are just gonna pop into the Metaverse and you're like, I don't know what's happening, like, just hit us up on Twitter. I'm kind of the queen of ghosting people, so maybe you won't, hopefully you'll hear back from me, but other people are better about that. So like everybody in the room, I would say, I know Brandon, I see you laughing at me, like I'd throw a follow to Don Julio Almunian and like, let's just embrace them. And if you're going to a party, just shoot a little invite and yeah, make them part of our community. Dr. Drip, welcome.
Hello, this is Brandon. Did I do okay? Is that okay?
I thought it was because of your blue check.
I'm super hot. Yeah, no, I'm practicing like having a deeper voice now that I have a blue check. I'm still practicing.
Wait, how'd you get that? Wait, I need that. Hold up.
Okay.
Did you pay $8?
Yes, I paid $8. You got to update your anyone who's interested. I feel so silly. I feel silly doing it, but like it's cool at the same time. So you update your phone, your Twitter on your phone, and then you go to Twitter Blue. It's $7.99 a month, and they just give you a check mark. You don't even have to verify. It's kind of weird.
What I spoke to one of my IRL friends last night, and he was like saying how that could have been like the move that will save Twitter, because like making a blue check mark so accessible by just paying $8 a month will make it so, well, it'll make it seem like having a blue check mark is like what you need to do, or if not, you're a bot. So it's like kind of creating that like FOMO for people.
Right. And it just came out today, and apparently they're doing a bunch of changes with Twitter that they're just spitballing to see what sticks and what doesn't. So who knows, maybe they'll take these check marks away or change them 100 times before they leave it. But anyways, I heard you guys talking about me. I was walking the dog, and I was on the computer for a bit. But, I wanted to come up and invite everyone to race, you know, anyone who's around before reset today. I've got some extra fuel, so I'm going to be hopping on once I finish my lunch in about 30 minutes here. I wanted to invite everyone to come race today at any time. Hit me up, and I'll come hit up the track. I'm just trying to get away from the guy that's winning first place all the time, because that means I get, like, second or third. And I'm never going to get up on that leaderboard. So like somebody, yeah, hit me up. Let's race. What else? So I'm going to spill the beans. Me and Brandon are working on a show. Sinful, you're a part of it. It's a wearable show. So I know that there's a lot of there are some platforms for people to come and talk about their projects. We all know and love Sinful's Beyond the NFT. But what I'm trying to do is make a little showcase in-game, primarily in-game, where we invite any creators. You could be a brand new creator. You're just going to have to fill out a form. It's really expensive. It's going to be like half an ETH. No, I'm just kidding. I'm so just kidding, because people try to pull that on me and... So it's free. It's totally free. It's our way of giving back. And also, I've never had a wearable launch party ever. And so, like, I even feel weird saying that. But so I wanted to make a platform where other people can have kind of a wearable launch party, but maybe not the ones that we're used to, where we all just kind of, you know, as much as I love them, I'm not talking down on them at all. But not ones where we just vibe out and just hang out and just party. More so, this one is going to be targeted towards sharing alpha, sharing the news about the project. Let's say you want to get up there, you just made, you know, a new video camera wearable. Brandon, I'm looking at you. Let's say you want to get up there and talk about all the perks that are coming for your holders and what people are getting for free. Or if there are no perks, you just want to get up there and talk about the colors or the story behind it, or you want to tell a story about how, you know, your first car was, you know, whatever. Like, you get up there and you talk about it until you got nothing else to say. We are going to recommend, you know, 30 to 1 hour slots, but it's exciting. It's in the works now. JW Designs contributed a build. I was going to build it myself, but they Mr. W really, really wanted to show off his new build skills. So I let him have creative freedom, and holy, oh my gosh, what he came back with. I was like, dude, you know I'm not paying you, right? Like, it's really amazing what he came back with. And so I'm working on it right now, getting it loaded up. And so we're looking to get that running in December. So, but yeah, that's the exciting news. We're still running full force with Vroomway. About the other stuff I've been working on, Voxboards collections, I finished up. So that's why I'm, you know, rocking and rolling on these other projects. But yeah, that's all I got. I'm kind of just rambling at this point. Save me, Sinful.
Love you, Dr. Drip. Thank you for coming up. Yes, we always have to show our love for you, Dr. Drip, even on the weeks that you don't decide to come up. And what the fuck? Coke Smush has a blue check mark now. That's not fair. I think the space needs to end soon so I can go get mine. Thank you, everyone, for coming up to speak. Dr. Drip?
I was just going to say blue check marks everywhere.
it's basically like just throwing $8 into a fire, just like, here, Elon.
But if you mint the name blue check mark, what would that be worth?
I'm minting that now. Brandon?
Before I drip, did you say the name of the show, or can we say that yet?
Yeah, tell him.
Oh, dude, it's so drip. Oh, my God. Drip's name, it's so good. It's called Fresh Mint. Ooh, you like that? So, we want to just talk to you guys. We want to get to know you guys. This is, again, community. We forget that there's actually people behind these dope-ass avatars. So, we want to get to inside of the brains of how you made your stuff. And one more thing tonight, let's just enjoy the quiet before the storm. Get in your Discords, like, get kicked back, get some smokes and drinks in tonight. Let's hang out one last time before the shit storm. That's it. Love you guys.
I'm not gonna be sleeping for days. One existence.
Since we're talking kind of blue checks and stuff, there was evidently a Twitter space just a bit ago that Elon was on. And I guess if anybody's familiar with Shirley Lowe, rest in peace. You will no longer see her in a Twitter space.
I miss Shirley. I commented on some of the posts of that were like, you know, just... I don't know. There were people that were getting very poetic. Like they were writing like bars about, you know, Shirley Lowe and how we will not see her anymore. I've been calling the term getting Elon'd.
Can we have like a cemetery in Decentraland for like all of the Twitters that were botted, bro? Like a little Shirley, like headstone, Shirley's Twitter headstone.
Per Shirley. Yeah, I think if we can come to a group vote, I'm totally down to support this idea. because I would expect someone to do it for me whenever I get Elon'd.
No, we can't do that. We have to protect each other. Don't let it happen.
I just want to say that I've found my sad sitting emote. It's so satisfying this week just being able to do that. So thank you, Knessa.
You're welcome. You know that emote actually. I never intended it to be like sad. It was more like, you're drunken and you just need to curl up and like rock yourself to kind of self-soothe. So, like, in my mind, it was never super sad. It was just more like, you just really need to sleep super bad. But well, I'm glad also, you guys are taking having
yeah,
fun.
Also, I mean, it's kind of cool because you're right. I mean, it's a little bit of a negative vibe, but it's not that I'm sad and that I'm feeling that way and I want people to think I'm sad as they walk up to me, but, like, more so when I take photos like that and I utilize it, it's so nice to be able to portray the, you know, other, I don't know, just to give different vibes. And even though a lot of times I'm being funny with it, right? Like I'm not actually sad, but, yeah, it's nice to have that kind of freedom to express ourselves. And when I was buying some of the negative ones, I bought some other ones that were just like, you know, like F you kind of stuff. There were some I bought, and it's just nice to be able to do that. So yeah, I wanted to thank you, because when you're building them, you're probably like, you know, this is negative, people are gonna be, but it's like it's still important to be able to express ourselves that way. So I want to say thank you.
Thank you, man. It actually, yeah, like I do have a underground agenda with a lot of the emotes. Like, I do want to convey emotion, because why would we have a wag me metaverse? Like, that is not real. The emotions are real. We should have them, you know, we have them in the real world. We have them there. Like, one day, Scott and I were talking about, you know, both of us leaving our jobs as educators. And like, I did use that emotion, and I was, he used an emotion. And I think we were both crying, like, you know, at home, just because it, like, we were talking about like real shit. And so there's other emotes that I'm making, and I can only work on them for a little bit. And then I got to like peace out, because I am trying to convey, you know, emotions through those. And like, a huge inspiration to me in a lot of the things I do is Walt Disney. And he had a saying with his movies that every movie he wanted to make, a movie should make you both laugh and cry. And so that's why, like, he put such dark shit in Bambi, you know, like, think about that. Or like,
oof, yeah.
Snow White. I mean, so it wasn't accidental. It was very intentional that he wanted people to feel both sadness and elation. And so I think, like, as I'm making emotes and putting them in the metaverse, like, that's what I want to do. And I'm also trying to make what I call social emotes, where you can't, the emote on its own has no value, has no meaning, like the heart one. Or what else? I can't even remember what other ones I made. Oh, the crowd surfing. Like, if you try to use them on your own, they're no good. But if you put them with somebody else, like, basically I'm trying to bring people together in a roundabout way. So then if you do the heart emote with another person, there's two different ways to make a heart. And so, yeah, that's my secret agenda. Not so secret, but just trying to bring people closer together and, like, build interaction between users.
I love it. I want to commend you for keeping it real, but also, like, the creativity in that, the fact that you found a kind of a niche in what you wanted to create, and utilized, I'm just going to call it, the new technology of, you know, emotes, in a creative way that no one's done yet. I do look forward to more people using it. Social emotes, I'm going to call it right now. But yeah, that's really cool. And that's creative. And I really liked the crowd surfing one, because it was more than just two people. And I'm definitely looking forward to seeing more creative uses of multiple people. So that's really dope. And I love that you're doing that.
Thank you.
And also, like, the fact that, at least, like, you know, the bridging the gap between the a wearable and an emote with the, you know, the bong hitting, the bong rip emote, or the cheers emote. So, like, that's also, like, another cool thing about what you're doing, Knessa. And, you know, you had just kind of mentioned how you're trying to bring emotion to all your emotes and stuff, and that's like what I love about your emotes. And then there's the other side, being the passed out emote. I've been doing that emote at like every party, just like passing out on like someone's couch. Or on a heart at Dollhouse, or in Casa Rustan's rotating bed.
It's so good for AFK.
I just wish like new, let's say, you know how like emotes, like let's say someone was on a scene before you, on a plot before you, and they started doing like a passed out emote, like, and you loaded in after, like, I wish the person that could load in after could see the emote that the person was doing, you know, before. Yeah.
I think, like, we got to remember, even though it's looped, we have to keep pushing it. So, like, I've been sitting on parcel, and I, every 5 minutes or so, I just hit my emote again. Because that way, anybody that came in during that time, like, I'll go back to that. And so I think we have to remember that. Just keep, it's looped for us. But if somebody crashes and they refresh, then they come back. Like, I refreshed about 10 minutes ago. I came back and everybody's standing. So then, like, it totally ruins the shot, like if you're gonna try to get people's actual positions. So just remember that, get the word out, keep spamming your little button, even if it's a looped one, so that everybody can get that experience. And so we can have Genesis Plaza like full of people just passed out on the benches and under the benches. And I apologize for bringing I'm just like, why? I don't know why I feel compelled to do these, but I guess it's just like, it's real life. You would just have people chilled. And I think that the couches at the True Band Room were the inspiration, because it looked, one day I was laying on it and I was like, ah, it looks like I'm falling off the couch. And then I was just like, what would reality be? Reality would be that you're just kind of like, you just got to sleep it off.
Wow. The True Band Room couches are the inspiration, yet I've passed out on the coffee table.
That's funny, because the height isn't the right height. So like when you're making emotes, it's extremely difficult to, like with this one where it has to match up with something in world, or it doesn't, you know, you're going to be floating or you're going to be sinking into it. So it probably took like 15 different tries of going back and like testing it out in the test editor and looking at the benches at Genesis Plaza and seeing where it fits. So a lot of these, it's extremely hard to get them to line up, or even the emotes that have the wearable. I've got a couple updates that have been pushed, like the bong rip, your hand. I mean, I probably see things that I'm like, ah, I don't like that, but maybe other people don't notice. But yeah, it's hard to see it. And then you have to just create it and hope it works and get it out there. But yeah, thank you guys for supporting and passing out everywhere.
Yeah, and thank you for sharing about the looping emotes, because I didn't know that at all. I just set my stuff on loop, and yeah, I could easily press it again to get people that just walked in to see it. So that's really cool. Thank you for sharing that info with us.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. I guess on that note, this is a positive note to end on. Thank you, everyone, for listening in for the last 2 hours and 47 minutes. I really appreciate everyone. Let's get back to the metaverse and just act natural, like we weren't just scheming for almost 3 hours. Love you all. Take care. And I'll see you later. Love you too, Brandon. Oh, wait. Are we getting... we have Decentraland coming up.
Yeah, nice move, Decentraland. That's like coming in at the last minute.
Sorry. I was doing work, but I just wanted to say I was listening to the space. Thank you.
Coming up, because that reminds me, next week, Wednesday the 16th, correct? The first AMA for the Decentraland Foundation will be happening.
Yes, the full lineup. I think I just tweeted it out this morning, so you can RSVP to those.
So everyone, make sure to RSVP, and also these AMAs will be at noon Eastern, so we will be moving our space to like 1 hour forward, so to 1 p.m. Eastern. I almost forgot to say that.
yeah, there's two of us here that almost forgot, so thank you, Decentraland.
Come hang out at the Meta Music Festival. What? I keep forgetting the fucking name of that thing. The Metaverse Music Festival in Decentraland. Ozzy Osbourne, Bjork is going to be there, you know. Come hang out. Love you guys. Y'all are cute. Drink some water.
Brandon's been hitting the wisher. Thank you, everyone. Oh, did you say you were going to pin a tweet, Kim?
Sure, I can, yeah. With the space.
Yeah. Or yes, thank you. Oh, I'm so excited now that I know there's a space to raid.
There is a surprise musical guest joining as well, so I recommend swinging by.
Wow.
Is this Soulja Boy?
I'm not at liberty to disclose any guests, but there's a fun one.
Good try, Brandon.
Well, me, you.
All right, I will see you all soon. I'm going to go prep for it, but have a good day.
Bye. Thank you. And I see Chotu, you request to speak. Welcome. We're closing up, but we'd love to hear from you if you've got any insight on some of the topics that we've covered. And on that note, I think we are probably good for the day, and we will see you guys on the flip side.
Take care, everyone.
You peacing out, Cheddar? Have a great day. I think I'm going to jump over to Genesis Plaza, see if we can help some new friends, find some new friends. Maybe even heat up a steak bowl, smoke a little more weed. You know, just the usual. Even though I'm totally enjoying the little shindig we got going on here at the... on Knessa's land. Like, I really love how everything, like, came out to be. the broken box board. Alrighty, so... let's go over here, close this. Should I leave the chairs and fire for the weekend? I mean, it looks fun, but like my only drawback that I could see is when like, you know, new users come and they don't have a sit emote. Maybe we could, if this is possible, here's a suggestion. Maybe put ask Grimy or put a link to the land that can where you collect the campfire sit emote, and kind of like put like a sign like free emote teleport here, and and then come back or something. Maybe we can ask Grimey to put a teleporter back. I might message him. Like just for the community sake. Do it. Okay, so where's my headphones? Gotta put some music on. A song that makes me want to kick doors down. I think it's this one. This song makes me want to kick doors down.
Tell me how you
feel. Nick is here. Well,
tell me.
Nick.
How it's like.
Oh, can't believe this shit. I bought so much Solana. I guess with my most recent purchase at like, what was it, 15? No, this is ETH. This is Matic. Oh shit, two of my Matic orders hit. My 75 and my 85. Oh my god. I got some Matic. Oh, damn. The 99 makes it bullshit. That means I can't withdraw it. No, I'll throw this Matic in the long bag. Matic is one of them tokens. Even though I do need to transfer all assets out of this account, like, ASAP, I should really stop using FTX. God, I love BTC today.
No!
Oh, Sugar Club, baby. What? I lied to everyone. I lied. I'm dropping by Sugar Club and saying hello to Sugar. Like, hello, Sugar Club. My name's Sinful. I am Cat. And then Sugar Club will be like, never heard of you. Get the fuck out of my club. You stink. Sugar Club. We get sugar tickets? What is this? How do we get in? Oh, meow. Haven't been here. Or at least to this field.
Shake and wave.
BTC scary today. The reason why I don't want BTC to fall is mainly because of like I see BTC as a oh my god I see BTC as like, you know, the token and that the crypto market is what's the best way to word this without sounding like a complete dumb shit. I feel like the entire crypto market follows Bitcoin. So like whatever Bitcoin does, it base like determines what the swing will be. It's okay to say you're a BTC maximalist. No, I am a mana maxi. That's me. Refraction, I don't know how to get up there. I don't know how to go party. Oh shit, I just remembered I need to close my YouTube.